One, two.
Good. Well, a lovely bit of tapping down there on the field from the Blackmail set dancers from Kilkenny and the Tubber set dancers from County Offaly. I think Kilkenny won that one by about a point. Well, a great scene here at Croke Park in the build-up to this year's All-Ireland Final. A match, of course, being watched not just by the attendants here and you all around the country, but indeed all around the world. Some of the Offaly supporters have actually gone to Lourdes for this game. I don't know if there's any significance in that, but we've been asked to say hello to Tom Martin and also to Pat and Jim and all the guys who are watching out in Lourdes on satellite television. That's from your brother Eugene. I'd also like to send best wishes, by the way, to Dick Dunphy from Mooncoin in County Kilkenny. Dick has been ill during the summer, and best wishes come to you from all in the Royal County. Cyril Farrell, briefly, that minor match, I mean, there was no question about it, well deserved by Cork in the end.
Well, just showing, like, Michael, we talked here about the breeze at half-time. Cork were only 2 points up coming in at half-time, but they were the 2 points up, second half, more against the breeze, and they played way better against it. They really won the game very comprehensively. And, like, they had beautiful forwards, like Colin McCarthy, Chip at all block, a bit light jet, but he will go to be a good one. Owen Fitzgerald, the wing, James Egan, like, they're all the big scorers. I suppose, now McCarthy came on as a sub, has played during the year, was lucky not to be starting today, was a bit sick, got a shoulder injury, came on and got 3 great points. So it shows you that they have kind of great strength, and as you were saying earlier on, they are going for another 21 title next Sunday or next Sunday in Turles. We hope to stop them in that, but like the future looks good for Cork. You know, really the second half Kilkenny only got a few points and you just can't win All Ireland doing that.
I think that second half goal, Tomás, unfortunate for the Kilkenny keeper, but that was the key score really, that sort of clinched it for Cork.
Yes, and just before that Kilkenny had one or two opportunities that they actually didn't take as well, but as we can see it here, it's a high ball that comes in from Jason Barrett, and it seemed to hang in the air for a long time, and the goalkeeper, obviously the sun was gone in that time, thought the ball was going over the bar, but it drops in underneath the crossbar, and it was a tonic of a goal for Cork, and they went from strength to strength after that and got some great scores. Here we see again, comes down off the crossbar in underneath the goal, and very little Jamie could do about it at the end of the day. I mean, look, you could see the sun is almost closing in his eyes from behind the goal there, and thought the ball was going over the bar, but unfortunately for him it went under, and it was a great goal for Cork, and a crucial score for Cork after half-time.
Well, some of the stars of the future, indeed of the present indeed for Cork, but some of the senior stars of the future, I'm sure, in action today. Right now, though, we're going to cast our minds back 25 years to when Limerick were the stars of hurling, claiming the All-Ireland title on that occasion. Interestingly enough, they beat Kilkenny in that final by 121 to 115. Well, the players that formed that team are now about to be introduced to the crowd here at Croke Park. Micheál Muirahearty is on the public address.
To take a free, you can see just outside the 70-yard line, and when Richie comes up to take a free, no matter where it is, you begin to wonder, is it going over the bar? It's blocked down by Noel Skeen, Pat Henderson, Eamon Grimes, and it's over the bar by Eamon Grimes. Getting it up to Mossy Dowling. Mossy, likewise, being bottled up by Van Larkin, getting his shot in and getting it over the bar. 5 minutes now and 7 points. We're near the final whistle. And it's Pat Hartigan out the field. Ball comes in from Liam O'Brien over the bar for a point. And look at the crowd lining behind the Limerick goal. That makes the score now 24 points to 17. One goal and 21 points for Limerick. 114 and Limerick are the champions. Just look at it.
Accord, I present to you the Irish Nationwide Building Society GAA Limerick Jubilee Team of 1973.
Yeah, there's a big, big welcome here for that wonderful team from Limerick from 1973. Victors, of course, against Kilkenny on that afternoon.
As then by their captain, Eamon Grimes.
Now, what a terrific player Eamon was indeed, part of a star-studded lineup that we all remember so fondly. And they've had a wonderful weekend here in Dublin. And indeed, the Limerick County Board have been very generous in their support to them.
It has been a long wait for the Limerick hurlers from 1940 when they won the All-Ireland until 1973. And the man that captained Limerick to that victory over Kilkenny, Eamon Grimes.
And a big warm welcome for Eamon Grimes.
And Eamon played in the centre of the field. The goalkeeper was Seamus Horgan.
Yes, many a very reliable and steady goalkeeper.
At right full back in the team was Willie Moore. In the centre of a magnificent full back line, Pat Hartigan.
Yeah, great full back. His daughter Faye, incidentally, is now an underage international basketball player.
In athletics as well. And to his left, looking as fit as ever, Jim O'Brien.
Great occasion for all these players to get back here.
The little dynamo, Philly Bennis.
Later became Limerick team coach and manager.
And the switch of the decade of the year from corner forward to centre back for that All-Ireland final, the great Eamon Cregan.
How appropriate he's back. What a big cheer he's getting for the day that Offaly play in the All-Ireland Hurling final.
And one of the stars on the big day, Sean Foley.
Yeah, he was a very classy halfback.
Lord Parker, the man whose point against Tipperary in the last minute got them the Munster title onto Croke Park, Richie Bennis.
He'll always be remembered for that particular score, last puck of the game.
The youngest on the field that day, only 19 years of age, Liam O'Donoghue.
Soldiered long in the Limerick colours down the years.
Centre forward, the man that always ran in a straight line, Mossy Dowling.
And another big welcome from everybody here from Ossie.
And at left half forward, the second member of the great Hartigan family, Bernie Hartigan.
Who, of course, was a tremendous athlete.
And like his brother, played hurling and football for Limerick. We move on to the full forward line of that day at corner forward, Frankie Nolan.
One of the great names.
And next to him were the two big men of the team. The full forward was Eamon Ned Ray,
who tormented many a full-back in his day.
And the import from Offaly, from Shinrone, Joe McKenna.
And another huge ovation for the great Joe McKenna.
The man of the team to have a racehorse named after him. The other hurlers who hurled well for Limerick that year and other years, Jim Hogan, the great goalkeeper. Jim O'Donnell, the magnificent centre-half back.
All of them enjoying the bright, fresh afternoon.
Tom Ryan, who later became manager of Limerick and brought him here twice in All-Ireland final day.
Manager, of course, in 1994.
Next to him, Jim Allis. And a great player over the years for Limerick as well, Father Paddy Fitzmaurice.
Yeah, the two Fitzmaurices, both
there
of them Terry's, of course.
Absentee. Andy Dunworth was called back to America, couldn't be here for the occasion. His nephew Cyril Dunworth is here to represent Andy Dunworth. Sheena Libby of the card, looking as fit as they were 25 years ago. The Irish Nationwide Building Society, GAA, Limerick team of 1973, Boulevard Smooth and Vuitton O'Limenagh.
The 1973 All-Ireland champions then, the Jubilee team this year. And of course, it's a long, long time since Limerick has won back that cup, all of 25 years. And that gap still to be bridged. So Eamon Grimes leading his team off, including Pat Hartigan, Pat's brother as well. Eamon Cregan, who we know so terribly well on the Sunday game programme. They tell us they've had a wonderful weekend here. Sadly, from their point of view, they won just one All-Ireland title. And what a fantastic sight this is. Close on 65, 66,000, I imagine, here this afternoon. One or two gaps way up in the high stand that you're seeing the pictures from, or close to it. Pitch a little soft following all the rain last night. And that's the canal end. And the canal end is populated by fans of the Cats. Kilkenny, of course, who've lost the minor. And it wasn't such a good start to the weekend for them either, because Michael Duxie-Walsh lost in the handball final last night. First time he's lost that title for 14 years. He lost to Walter O'Connor of Meath by 21-14, 21-17. And now the arrival of Antishuk, great sports follower that he is, Bertie Ahern, alongside Liam Mulvell, Director General of the GAA. Taoiseach loves nothing more than coming to a big match here, or indeed any kind of a match here, Sunday after Sunday. So he goes to take his spot then in the Ord Coryla section. match now, the senior game, just about 22 minutes away.
Yes, the Taoiseach in a fortnight's time will be back here again, of course, with his colleague Charlie McCreevy. They'll be looking forward, at least Charlie will anyway, to perhaps securing their victory on that occasion. However, today it's about the hurling final. Who's going to win this one? Well, we've seen the two names on the team sheets filled in now, Cyril Farrell. We have Ken O'Shea coming in for Kilkenny and Gary Hanafy for Offaly.
Yeah, Gary Hanafy came on the last day, Michael, and got three great scores in the second half. And I suppose going on form, they probably picked him. Now, it'll be a hard look on Paddy Mulhere here because he has played well all season. And there's a feeling in Offaly that they would play him and Gary would be the trump card coming on again. Ken O'Shea, I know from the Kilkenny training camp, you know, there was rumours like that he would make it. He's playing very well in training, has a lot of pace. There will be a big question mark after tonight because Niall Maloney will be feeling, you know, that he should be on. But Niall Maloney seems to be a player that when he comes on, get these vital goals. So yeah, they probably feel that they're stronger with that unit starting.
Well, a great build-up here in Croke Park at the moment, Tomás Mulcahy, because what's actually happening is the crowd here are watching the patch to the final on the big screen and cheering every score along the way as well. A lot of talk about the clash of DJ Carey and Brian Whelehan in this match. Will it actually happen, Tomás?
They probably might start on each other, but I'd say after a while, I think that DJ may be moved around, you know. Everybody's expecting a big game from DJ today. I mean, he's coming into the game under tremendous pressure, I mean, to do well. And I'm sure himself, he'll be anxious with his first few frees that he can put them over the bar and build on his confidence from there, because there's a lot resting on his shoulders today.
Well, to us, here comes the Kilkenny team for the 1998 All-Ireland Senior Hurling Final.
Yes, the Leinster champions on 56 occasions, bringing their own particular brand of hurling magic back to Croke Park, where they're playing in their 47th All-Ireland final. They're just one of three counties, of course, whose winning record reaches double figures. Cork with 27 wins, Kilkenny with 25, Tip with 24. And you know, at the start of the year, even as late as May, experts in Kilkenny were saying to us, forget about a Cats victory this year in the All-Ireland. DJ had retired and come back again. But generally something was perceived to be missing. And was that ingredient basic confidence? Canis Brennan there. Andy Comerford looking tense. Titch Phelan there as well. Liam Cowan. And we go right down the line there. They have tradition. They have freshness. Remember, just one major match, the semi-final of the All-Ireland, played by the Cats in 10 weeks. So they should be the fresher of the two teams. Well, they had one major problem heading into the final. That was to decide whether it should be Niall Maloney or somebody else at top of the right. It's somebody else who's got the spot. Number 18, Kenny O'Shea. Elsewhere is a defence built around the muscular presence of Pat O'Neill and the hurling skills of Willie O'Connor. Philly Larkin and Peter Barry maintain their working relationship in midfield. While up front, don't be too surprised if the Cats opt at some stage for a two-man full forward line of Charlie Carter and PJ Delaney. DJ Carey continues to be their trump card. And looking down through their list of subs, it does, of course, include Niall Maloney, number 13. Also Dennis Byrne, number 21, whose brother Declan is watching this match at home. He's wished well by everybody and anybody. Kevin Fennelly, the team manager. He's done really well to take them from what was presumably the depths of despair towards the beginning of the year, all the way here to an All-Ireland final. And there he is, the man in the black peaked cap. Played in an All-Ireland final himself, so he knows the pressure, he knows what it's all about. And he's been able to guide his goalkeeper, Joe Dermody, and just to tell him what to expect, the pressure, the tension, and so on. I can tell you that the wind has dropped down a little bit as we take a quick little look here at Tom Hickey, who'll be hoping he fares a bit better than his two brothers, who, of course, were playing in the minor match before here. He's captained by virtue of Dunamagan's wonderful county success last year when they beat Young Ireland's DJ Carey's team. Here's PJ Delaney. Delaney today playing in his 18th championship match, and look at that for a splash of colour up there at the canal end. And now it's the turn of Offaly, Leinster champions on 9 occasions. They return back into the All-Ireland final day, 6th time ever to compete for the Liam McCarthy Cup on finals day. An amazing season is drawing to a close. Favoured by many for provincial honours, they dethroned Wexford, playing poorly with a late goal. Lost to Kilkenny, controversially, the colourful Babs Keating parted company with them then, Michael Bond, largely unknown at that time, came in for John Troy and his team. That's Simon Whelihan there. Stephen Byrne, who was absolutely magnificent in the third match in that series against Clare. So too, Joe Dooley. And even after they came through the quarter-final stage with a dull victory over Antrim, they finally got the measure of the defending All-Ireland champions, Clare, who seemed weary after their exertions. And now the big question to be asked of Michael Dignam and Johnny Pilkington and Kevin Martin: can Offaly reproduce their simple stadium form? That is the big, big question. And Kevin's sister, Frankie, is watching this on honeymoon in Portugal. Well, Offaly's vacancy at half forward was a tricky one to fill. Did they go with Paddy Mulhare, whose preparations were ruined for the last two matches because of the death of his father, or Gary Hanafy? Well, they've decided that it's Hanafy who will start, wearing number 23. 12 of the players have played in All-Ireland senior finals. And as regards the places they will fill, well, it should be a repeat of Thurles, I feel. Johnny Dooley and Johnny Pilkington, I imagine, may well be in midfield. Joe Dooley probably anywhere but full forward. Probabilities here as well of Joe and John Troy at some stage or other liaising in a two-man full forward line, at least at some stage in the course of the 70-minute final. And I looked through the substitutes for Offaly, and they've got plenty of players in there who have championship experience, including the aforementioned Paddy Mulhare, cousin of one of the selectors, Podge Mulhare. And of course, Barry Whelihan there, he played against Kilkenny the last time the sides met, which was in the Leinster final itself, and the manager, Michael Bond. So many questions to be resolved. That's Michael Bond, who simply has come in and done a terrific job, no question or doubt about that. He's given them discipline, he's given them confidence as well, as we go across now and join our sideline reporter, Marty Morrissey.
Thank you very much, Ger. Well, I can tell you there is genuine concern in both camps about the state of the pitch, particularly Offaly. Very much Podge Mulhare and Michael Bond concerned that the pitch has cut up so much as a result of the minor match. No fault in Croke Park officials, but the heavy rain, anybody who was in Dublin City last night will realise how much of a downpour there was in the capital. However, they're hoping for the best. Interesting moods in both camps. Offaly very, very calm and very confident. Michael Bond spoke calmly to the players. Brian Whelan was the player going around to each one and saying, come on, this is going to be our day. Kilkenny went to the back of the dressing room where there was nobody at all, and there was a lot of roaring and shouting and a lot of bouncing on the feet as such, and saying that this was going to be their day and that the homecoming was going to be in Kilkenny City and around County Kilkenny tomorrow. But otherwise, no news from the sideline except that both teams are still confident despite the conditions of the pitch.
Yes, actually, it was quite obvious looking at the team lineups there as they sat on the bench for the photographs, and both teams very, very tense and very, very anxious going into this final. Dickie Murphy now having his picture taken with the opposing captains. They have, of course, already met this year in the championship in the Leinster final, and that, I suppose, obviously, a major backdrop to this afternoon's game and the tension that it brings with us. Cyril Farrell, to pick up on the point that Marty Morrissey was talking about there, the condition of the pitch, it cut up very badly in that minor match. Now, before, at the beginning of the programme, before the minor game, you talked about this, and you talked about the heavy sod out there.
Yeah. Michael, I actually walked the pitch early this morning. I couldn't believe it. Now, I know it has rained very heavy here all night, but, like, it really cut up, and, like, it's not the fault of the authorities that the pitch cut up, because, like, you know, that's the weather that we have in Ireland. But it begs the question, like, should we put back, in actual fact, maybe we should put in the calendar the other way around, yeah, put the championship more in the summer than we can, because you're leaving yourself open every... Now, these are the two top teams in the country at the moment, their biggest day of the year, and there's no doubt about, like, the pitch conditions are not the best conditions that we should have. We saw in the divots, which is very unusual in Croke Park, and, you know, it's going to suit some players. Usually it suits backs, because it kind of slows down that ball a little bit, but you're going to have very little fluent ground hurling.
Okay, well, I suppose the only thing about it is, Tomás, you could have had the All-Ireland final in the middle of June this year. It wouldn't have made any difference because it was still wet. Now, before we talk to you about who's going to win this match, briefly, you want to say hello to somebody.
Yes, I just want to say hello to two clubmates of mine. They're actually watching this match in Melbourne today in Australia in the Normandy Hotel. I think there's a bit of a bet on there for a few points that they actually know me, so they're watching the match with a lot of Australians outside, and I'm sure a lot of Kilkenny and Offaly people, so I just want to say hello to those guys.
Who's going to win this final?
I've gone for Kilkenny, and I'm going to stick with Kilkenny. I think if there's goals to be scored today, I think Kilkenny forwards are the ones who can do that.
Cyril?
I'm going for Offaly really, because like, they are coming from playing, you know, a lot of matches. The only thing that worries me a little bit, looking at them there closely, coming up on the bus and getting off again, they're very, very tense. I just hope like both teams release the tension. The only one that looks happy and relaxed out there is Dickie Murphy.
Well, Dickie is always happy and relaxed out there. Offaly, of course, were the All-Ireland champions, most of this team, just 4 years ago. They know what it's about.
Offaly have contested, it's their third in 4 or 5 years, and they've been around, they've won minor championships, they won club All-Irelands, and like, they're used to the big occasion, they're used to Croke Park, which is very important. They have very few new players in, and the ones that have been, like, you know, Stephen Burton, Simon Whelan, you know, and Gary Hannafy are good players. Now, Kilkenny, on the other hand, like, in a final, there's something else, Michael. They never really play bad. They have been very, very quiet. That's the way they love to win. And the word from the training camp is that they're going very, very well. And, of course, there's big pressure on DJ today. Like, you know, they'll be all saying, you know, is he going to deliver a big one? To me, he has nothing to prove. He has been the best hurler ever. Like, an RTE will do him.
OK, Cyril Parra, thank you for the moment. Well, the players are lining up in front of the red carpet now because they're about to be introduced to the President of Ireland, Mary McAleese.
So President Mary McAleese, her first time as president to come here to an All-Ireland hurling final, going straight away over to Hubert Rigney, who will introduce his colleagues. And of course, President McAleese there, accompanied by Joe McDonough, Ron Cumann, and Luke Lascoil. One man sadly missing the proceedings today from an Offaly point of view is the president of the Offaly County Board. He's Father John McWee of Kilcock, and he's convalescing at present. Wish well. Martin Hannaby there with the red helmet. Right through then to Brian Whelehan. Yes, it's going to be interesting to see whether it'll be Brian Whelehan versus DJ Carey as the match pans out. Johnny Dooley, will he start in midfield? And of course, it's Joe Erity, who wear number 11, the giant Gary Hannafy there, John Troy. And of course, Joe Dooley, very calm, looking for his third All-Ireland winner's medal this afternoon. That's the Offaly team. Now to the match officials, and of course the first for the referee as well. It's his fourth All-Ireland final for Dickie Murphy, but the first time he's refereed the same two teams in the championship finals in the same championship season. He's been refereeing, of course, since his teens, and he's from the Rapparees Club at Enniscorthy in Wexford, ably assisted today by his linesman Sean McMahon of Clare and Pat O'Connor of Limerick. So on to the Cats and Tom Hickey, the team captain, just 23 years of age, introducing his colleagues. So much pressure, so much tension. Let's wish them all well. And also the wish to each and every one of the players that they have a really good game. Marvellously talented hurlers of Kilkenny and Offaly. They've trained professionally. They're about to give them their best. They'll be winners, they'll be losers. But can they overcome the inevitable nerves, which are all part of being potential champions? No one wants to fail. So again, to the officials and the players, the very best of luck to everybody. The crowd today, a capacity 65,000. Everybody wants to be here for the final itself. By comparison, in July, the place was half empty for the Leinster final. And of course, only 9,500 bothered turning up for the 1980 Leinster final between the same two counties today. Offaly finally made the breakthrough. And a very smiling and youthful President of Ireland making her way off. Glorious afternoon. Concern about the softness of the pitch. So now it will be the parade of the teams. Kevin Martin had a stormer in the match in Semple Stadium, but that was just 2 weeks ago. It's a game which may further give us proof as to what's the best preparation for an All-Ireland final. Is it game after game, or is it a long rest? Most people would argue that the very least Offaly would have needed was perhaps a three-week break. The Mayor of Dublin, Seamus O'Regan there as well, former president of the GAA, all of them in the Ardcoyle section. And just look and listen to the sounds from Croke Park just before the beginning of the 110th All-Ireland hurling final. There was no final in 1887, no final again in 1911. Offaly hoping to win the cup for the fourth time in their history. Remember Kilkenny with 25 All-Ireland wins, the first in 1904, the last in 1993. And a quick check once again on the Kilkenny team for the afternoon. They had a big decision to make. Who was going to play at top of the right? It's Kenny O'Shea who gets the nod. He's been coming on as sub time and again, but he's in there this afternoon to start to figure, this time in his seventh championship match. And the Offaly team, a quick reminder of that as well, and the various numbers that they're going to wear this afternoon, although somebody like Joe Erity there, number 11, might well be expected to play at full forward and be marked by Pat O'Neill. Gary Hanafy, the one who comes in, wears number 23 and plays in his eighth championship match. That's on foot of a very, very good display when he was sprung from the bench in the third match in that wonderful series against Clare. Clare is still very much in our memories, very much regarded by all and sundry as the unluckiest team of the year. Lucky that is not to be here to be shaping up to one of these teams, but it's Hubert Rigney's side who've made it through the end of the second year of this experimental phase, whereby the losing team in the Munster and Leinster championships got back into the All-Ireland series, and will awfully be the ones who will come through and take the title. Many people fancy them, others say you can never ride off a Kilkenny team. Such a transformation from 18 years ago when the same counties met in that Leinster final. Not many gave Offaly a chance. Most considered it unwise to bother spending time or money on a game that Kilkenny were expected to win comfortably. They didn't, of course. They lost by just a point in a wonderful match. But what will today bring? As we've seen here, the usual splash of colour. Indeed, a wonderful, colourful exchange, great banter, great noise, and great expectation as well, as the teams continue their parade, going down now towards the Offaly fans on Hill 16. There it is, up on the right. I'm happy to report that both sides are staying behind the van, continuing the tradition, and nobody's breaking away fast. Tom Hickey leading the men of Kilkenny, behind him Joe Dermody. And I just wonder whether Joe is wearing a golden horseshoe, a lucky charm around his neck. It's something that his grandmother, a Mrs. Butler, gave to Pa Dillon when Pa played in his first ever All-Ireland Hurling Final. And last night Pa gave back the lucky charm to Joe Dermody and said, wear it, and the best of luck to you. The Nally stand. Just about every space taken up. It's the day when everybody wants to be here. A uniquely Irish occasion. A match which has been watched all over the globe today. And wherever you're watching it, hope you enjoy it. Let's hope it's a good one. Johnny Pilkington just retrieving the stick. The giant screen up there in the background, which allows the public here to have a quick little look at the various replays of points, goals, incidents and so on. That's Christine Carey there, who is DJ's wife. Tense. Remember, it is Kilkenny who won the toss. They're going to play from right to left in the first half, which means they will be playing against the wind. Now, I'm not sure is the breeze quite as strong as it was when we were doing a weather report and a pitch check round about 1 o'clock with Pete Finnerty. It's blowing across towards Dublin Bay at that particular point, but it can be very, very deceptive. Michael Bond's first experience to take a side through to the senior All-Ireland final, the man from Athenryan, Galway. Now the crowd being asked to stand, show respect, face the tricolour and listen and join in for our national anthem. Thank you.
goal setting. Frank Commons there, just on the left-hand side, former Kilkenny star. So two sides ready to give it everything. And indeed, Johnny Dooley has gone into midfield, as I anticipated. It's been watched all over the globe, including in the Cayman Islands, where Adrian Lynch, formerly of the Piercing in Limerick and latterly the Fianna in Dublin, is watching. Hope you enjoy it. The referee is Dickie Murphy. Brian McAvoy and DJ Carey have also switched wings. Referee Dickie Murphy taking charge of his fourth senior final, 1992, 1995, 1997, and now 1998. Michael Dagnan's gone to right half forward as the match gets underway, and Joe Erity's gone into full forward straight away, sending in that ball towards Joe Dooley. Joe here challenging the team captain for Kilkenny. They try to make some headway, they've got a great chance. Joe Dermody was out quickly, Billy Dooley was in there, and the referee says, hang on, that's going to be a free out. And already you can see just how soft the ground conditions are down there in front of Joe Dermody's goal. Well, this was a very near thing indeed, as Billy Dooley was coming in, and there was a wild pull, and the referee says, free out to Kilkenny, to be taken by Joe Dermody. Joe playing in his sixth championship match, sending it way down. Martin Hannemy comes out here. Two very able defences on view this afternoon. Philly Larkin in midfield, sending it down towards Charlie Carter. Will it be Charlie's day? PJ Delaney trying to get onto it here. First chance then for PJ Delaney. Leaving it right in there. DJ Carey's trying to take it up onto his stick. Out it comes, and it's Brian Whelan who gets it clear. Back again by Camus Brennan. What an atmosphere. What a start. Peter Barry driving it back in there. Kevin Keenahan's under it. PJ Delaney trying to get his stick to it. Andy Comerford and the referee, calm as you like, is in there to see a chop, and it's going to be a free in. Having a word there with the Offaly captain, Hubert Rigney from St. Rhina's. The point is made already that Dickie always seems one of the most composed, one of the most relaxed officials ever, no matter what the atmosphere, no matter what the occasion. DJ Carey, first chance of a score. He's outside the 20-metre line. Will he roll it over the bar? Yes, he will. So DJ Carey gets his first point of the match, Kilkenny's first chance. And just look out for his frees when he gets them near the 20-metre line, because he has scored 20 goals in his championship career, and 9 of them have been against Offaly. Stephen Byrne with the puck out. Towards Gary Hanafy's corner. Breaks loose, however. Peter Barry trying to link up there with Tom Hickey. Erity firing it back there towards Johnny Dooley, looking for the equaliser, but he's put it to the left. So just a reminder again that it's Johnny Dooley who's playing in midfield alongside Johnny Pilkington. Michael Dignan's right half forward, Brendan Waugh there in the centre, the Offaly chairman, urging on the side alongside Podge Mulhare. John Troy's on the 40, Gary Hanafy's left half forward, and then the full forward line, Billy Dooley's on the right, Joe Dooley's on the left, and in between them it's Joe Erity. This breaks across here towards Brian McAvoy, as I said earlier, switched with DJ Carey. That's Andy Comerford, really works hard for Kilkenny. Peter Barry on his knees, took the ball off the ground with his hand, not allowed, free to Offaly. Here's Brian Whelan to hit this one. It's his 28th time to play championship. What a servant of Offaly he's been down the years. Canis Brennan trying to catch this one, catching it magnificently, then he's fouled. He started well, Canis Brennan. Batted away the first ball that came his way, caught the second one. And then the man he is marking this afternoon is John Troy. Pat O'Neill hitting the free. Over the head there of Ryan McAvoy. That's Simon Whelan. Down on his hands and knees, the referee preparing to throw the ball in. Andy Comerford and Hubert Rigney going to be the two contesting for this one. Here comes McAvoy. Chance of another score, and he's put it over the bar. Brian McAvoy's first point, Kilkenny's second. They've made the better start. Following the throw there, it was swiftly taken by Brian McAvoy, showing courage and dash, and a good finish. with boundless energy is Brian McAvoy. Playing it left half forward. Peter Barry trying to take it away from the attentions there of Johnny Dooley. Held further away by Michael Cavanagh initially. Brian Whelihan. His stick is broken. He'll need a replacement quickly as we watch Johnny Dooley set off. Willie O'Connor, what a match he played in the semi-final. Willie again trying to deny Billy Dooley, sending it in towards his brother Joe, swiftly hitting it on the ground, but couldn't quite get it on target. Now 35 years of age, of course. Joe playing today in his 45th championship match. And some early news now of this match from the sideline from Marty Morrison.
Well, as we've reported in other games involving Kilkenny, they always have somebody. Normally it's Brendan Finlay up in the stand communicating with the selection committee. Kevin Finlay has no earpiece today. The man that's communicating with Brendan Finlay is Dick O'Neill from the Young Ireland Club.
Yeah, I saw him getting wired up before the match round about a quarter to three. Tom Hickey almost picked that ball off the ground. Play continues. Peter Barry, dispossessed, comes back to Johnny Dooley. Sending it in towards Joe Erity. It goes beyond him, however. Not a good ball in, and it's an easy one in the end for Joe Dermody to take away. Big, huge cheer from the Kilkenny following as he drives it downfield. Kevin Martin blocked down. Nipping in here, DJ Carey on his way. McAvoy's after it, so too Simon Whelihan, and he leaves it in the end for Stephen Byrne. Very astutely picking out Johnny Pilkington. Huge one down in beyond the corner back. Pat O'Neill, however, the fullback, comes across. Can't prevent it going out over the sideline. He's a big, tough customer, Pat O'Neill. Won, of course, one of the man of the match in the 1992 final. Might well have won it in 1993 as well. This to be taken in the end by Johnny Pilkington. Michael Dagnan moving infield. Offaly just needing a score now to try and settle them down. So we're almost 6.5 minutes gone. A chance for Pilkington to cut it. Inside it goes there. Geraghty was whipping on it. Out it comes again. This time Michael Dagnan, quick change of direction. And it ends up going over the bar. So Offaly finally get off the mark in the 7th minute of this match. From the sideline ball, in it went in there to Michael Dagnan, and he did the rest. Hubert Rigney beaten for this one by Andy Comerford. Comes out to Kevin Martin, great wrist work. Out to John Troy, they need a big game from Troy. Just as Kilkenny need a big game from DJ Carey. Joe Dooley. Man of the match in the last game, and he sends this one over the bar. That'll do his confidence an awful lot of good. Sets the equaliser, and it's Joe Dooley who provides it. This is how he did it, went out towards the sideline, took Tom Hickey with him, but had the confidence to strike a beautiful point. Referee is out in the middle of the field there, player needing attention, and the player in question appears to be Hubert Rigney. Dr. Brendan Lee and Michael Bond there as well, the manager, blow to the face clearly. Hubert's fairly quiet by nature, but the captaincy has brought him out a little bit more because he really is quite shy. But if they win the cup, well, he'll have to make the presentation speech. Very, very tense and anxious faces everywhere, but it's a glorious occasion. Hubert's okay. So Joe Dermody once again. Johnny Pilkington contesting this time, beating Philly Larkin to it. Larkin will have to stick very, very tight on Johnny Pilkington, who by his own standards hasn't had a particularly good season. But here he is playing an All-Ireland final, same as Brian McAvoy. Players calling for it. McAvoy striking it with a lot of power. It comes out off the post and out and wide. So just a first wide then for Kilkenny. Brian McAvoy has already scored. Michael Bond pacing up and down the sideline. As we said, not an awful lot was known about him before the time he became manager, but he's had a long spell with Galway and with Galway clubs. This is Michael Kavanagh. under 21 fullback as well. Kevin Martin beaten for it there. Sent back up again towards Joe Erity. Between Erity and Pat O'Neill. Two big strong fellows. O'Neill one-handed away. Taken away by John Troy. Back to Joe Dooley. Can he replicate the earlier score? Not on this occasion. Joe a little bit annoyed with himself there because Offaly have already stuck three wides. Andy Comerford down there in the centre, hoping to try and really solve that problem for Kilkenny on the 40. Comes back into the face of the Kilkenny backs again. Michael Kavanagh. Johnny Pilkington getting onto it. Nice hand pass back to Brian Whelihan. Whelihan, a good low ball inside to Joe Erity. Good play. Erity turning. And that's a fine score. Joe Erity from Burr, the point scorer. But it was the quality of the pass that made it all possible. Johnny Pilkington sensibly looking up, giving the right kind of ball into Erity. Not much the fullback could do about it. And Offaly lead. Hubert Rigney, sun in his eyes at this stage. And the rest of the Offaly backs. Charlie Carter coming in here. It's down! What a start by Charlie Carter! Charlie the man to deliver. Questions will be asked about the Offaly backline, however. How was he allowed that latitude? He got it and he availed of it. It was a wonderful finish by Charlie Carter. The man who got 1-5, of course, in the Leinster final against the same opponents. He's done it again. That's a great catch by Kenneth Brennan. Kilkenny go back in front again by 2 points. Martin Hanamy knocking that one away. Two great rivals here in Leinster, in this All-Leinster-Ireland final. Michael Kavanagh delivering that one inside. Hubert Rigney needing a second, but great ground hurling, getting it forward towards Joe Dooley. Tom Hickey battling away in there to deny the veteran Offaly man. Here's Michael Kavanagh. Martin Hanamy, over his head it went to PJ Delaney. That came off the fullback Kevin Kinahan, and it'll be a sideline ball for Kilkenny. PJ Delaney's dad, of course, Pat, was a star in the past for Kilkenny, and in particular in the 1969 Leinster final involving Kilkenny and Offaly, when Kilkenny won by 2 points, they got 3 goals in the match, and it was Pat Delaney who got all the goals. Andy Comerford, not a good ball in, but it might come good yet. Charlie Carter hand-passing it back out, scoop back out again to Andy Comerford, and that's over. Didn't look too promising when the ball was hit in from the sideline, but Andy Comerford gets his first point of this final to really boost his confidence. Scooped beautifully out there by Brian McAvoy as far as Comerford, and over it sailed. Canis once again making a wonderful catch. Canis Brennan, brother of Nicky, the former manager. Brian Whelihan having to scamper after this one. Trying to link up with his brother, Victor, is robbed, and it's Charlie Carter who has it, firing away to top of the right, just as Kenny O'Shea had moved in, the number 18. So far, it's all Martin Hanamy down there. He was being dragged back, and not much doubt about the referee's decision. Most of the balls that have come down there between Kenny O'Shea and Martin Hanamy have been won by the St. Rhinas man so far, but Kenny O'Shea has the ability to get goals. Some switches in the Offaly forward line. Just noticing Joe Erity has gone out to try and cut down on the dominance of Canis Brennan. But here's Brennan once again, leaving it for Pat O'Neill. As you can see, John Troy has now gone into full forward. O'Neill called into action once again, and one hand is scooping it out over the sideline. A man who has prepared assiduously for this particular final, Pat O'Neill. So now it's going to be Johnny Pilkington to take the sideline cut. Offaly needing a little something in front of goal. John Troy trying to provide a bit of a cutting edge for them. Joerity, beaten to it by the determination of Tom Hickey, comes out to Peter Barry. Nicely gathered here by DJ Carey. At this stage, his right half forward on Kevin Martin, sending that one in low towards Charlie Carter. Good ball. Oh, Cubitt Whitney, and in the end, picked up by Simon Whelan for Offaly. Nicely downfield towards Gary Hanafy. Haven't seen much of him in the early exchanges. Trying to get it out of danger. Joe Dooley, 45 metres out, back down. Comes to Peter Barry. Sending it back towards Carter once again, who's drifted across to the right-hand side. Now without the hurley, beaten. Well, I thought he was going to be beaten, but he got there through sheer determination. Now Kenny O'Shea. Sending it across dangerously. Oh, it stopped on the goal line. Brian Whelan making the clearance. That was very nearly goal number two for Kilkenny. Ripped away there by Johnny Dooley. Kilkenny having the edge of midfield. Andy Comerford across here towards Brian McAvoy once again. Again, the Cats come ready. That's a wonderful stroke away that time by Johnny Pilkington. Comes out to Brian McAvoy, sending it in high and sending it over the bar. A second point for Brian McAvoy, doing well against Brian Whelan. And Kilkenny lead 1-4 to 3 points. This was the near miss a couple of minutes ago as Kenny O'Shea was coming in. And just look, ball in the end swept off the line there, and Brian Whelan taking it further away from danger. Stephen Burns puck out. Again going towards Gary Hanafy's wing. Big, tall, strapping fellow, but beautiful work here by Philly Larkin. His dad and grandfather, of course, All-Ireland medal winners in the past. DJ Carey getting that one forward, was PJ Delaney, Kevin Keenahan. Some of the Offaly backs a little bit loose in their marking. Great determination again by Kilkenny, been illustrated here in DJ Carey. Wants to play a really big game. Kilkenny are perceived to be below their best so far in this championship. Kevin Martin's down injured. Rip play continues, but the referee has gone in to attend to Kevin Martin. He's back up on his feet again as Canis Brennan is prepared to clear the ball. But he can afford to take a little tea break. Referee is in there, making sure that the Offaly player can get the attention he requires. Kevin Martin happily back up on his feet again. So it's going to be a free downfield. And there's a switch here, which has been made. And Brian Whelan is going into the forward line at right half forward. And it's Michael Dignan who has gone back to pick up Brian McAvoy. That is an interesting switch made so early in this match. So Brian Whelan, one of the best backs in the country, now playing in the forwards. Pat O'Neill magnificently taking this one. And Michael Bond has a habit, of course, of switching around his players time and again, trying to keep them on their toes and keep the opposition thinking. That's a sideline ball in spite of the best efforts of Michael Kavanagh. Sean McMahon there, the Clare man who is on the line at that far side. Johnny Pilkington waiting to hit this one in. 4 points separating the teams. And the referee, I think, wants a bit more urgency. Nicely cut in. Could have ended up anywhere if anybody had been able to get a stick to it, in particular Joe Dooley, who was in there lurking. That's four wides now that Offaly are guilty of as we go back to the sideline and Marty.
Yeah, the general belief here is, I think, around us here in the Cusick stand is that it's a plan by Offaly to move Brian Whelan after he did so well against Clare into the attack. But from the Offaly dugout, it appears that they weren't happy with the way Brian Whelan was defending against Kilkenny, and it was just decided on the day, this moment, to move him into the attack.
Yeah, let's see how it pans out as Joe Dooley gets it back towards Johnny Pilkington. Now there's a bit of space here. It's Johnny Dooley who hits it, and that should really have been over the bar. Instead, it's away to the left. A shake of the head by Johnny. Well, that was a bad miss. Offaly not playing particularly well. And the Kilkenny mentors, with Kevin Fennelly and his selectors, of course, continuing to issue the instructions, the fellow selectors being Mick McCarthy and Dick O'Neill. So Michael Dignan now at right half back. Couldn't hold on to that one. Andy Comerford trying to get it through somehow. Just got a little flick of it there out as far as Brian McAvoy. Nicely in towards Charlie Carter, but The bounce of the ball a bit unkind for him, perhaps the pitch at fault there. That's Simon Whelehan opting to kick that ball away once again towards Gary Hanafy. Billy Dooley, nice pick up. He's going for the score himself, but really, the last two misses now by Johnny and by Billy are something that they may well rue before the end of this match, because that was hit from about 70 metres out, and there were players in better positions inside. He won't be pleased. The Offaly inside forward line now reading John Troy, Joe Dooley and Billy Dooley. Meanwhile, back in midfield, Hubert Rigney picking it up. Doing well, anchoring the Offaly half-back line. Johnny Pilkington firing it away and again. And there's hesitation, and that's supposed to have picked off the ground. The referee appealing for it inside there. It perhaps could be a 20-metre free-in. They're racing in quickly. And the umpire will certainly have a view on that, I think. Dickie Murphy then, signalling, I think, that it's going to be a free-in. This is what happened again. So the referee then awarding this free. Now it should be an ordinary 20-metre free-in because the goalkeeper picked the ball off the ground inside that little rectangle. The result of that is an ordinary 20-metre free. That's the rule. Here's John Troy, and he's content to put it over the bar. It also happened in another match earlier this season, as it's won 4-4 points. And I think on that particular occasion it was Brendan Cummins, the Tipperary goalkeeper, picked the ball off the ground. And of course the rule is an ordinary free from 20 metres out. So three between them. A game which, in spite of that goal by Charlie Carter, has really yet to fire into life. Johnny Dooley. Can he inspire the midfield? Nice ball down along towards Joe Dooley. Again, the ball bouncing unkindly. Pat O'Neill gets it away as far as Brian McAvoy is settling down to play a good match. Dispossessed this time by Brian Whelehan. Back to the new man at right half back. Michael Pilkington, or Michael Dignan, fouled as he was kicking the ball away. And we've seen so many players today resort to kicking it away rather than hurl it away. Free to Offaly. Dignan, hurler and footballer, of course, in the past. Brian Whelehan, in spite of going into the forwards, has come back to try and hit this free. It's on his own 65-metre line. It's a huge one, and it lands over the bar. A very valuable free converted there by Brian Whelehan. His first point of the day. And that was from his own 65-metre line. Joe Dermody ready to pop this ball out. Only 2 points separating the teams. Midway through the first half. Johnny Dooley contesting in there with Peter Barry, and it's Dooley who takes it away. He's received a gash in the head, I can tell you, as well, as he was clashing for that one. Up as far as his brother Billy. Billy lobbing it in again, and this time it's the goalkeeper who has the easy task of coming out and making the clearance. Johnny is going to need attention pretty soon, but he's hurling away right now. Andy Comerford trying to beat Michael Dignan. Johnny Pilkington coming in here. Good sidestep, nice hand pass away. Brian Whelehan, blocked down brilliantly there by Liam Keown. Michael Dignan again. Dispossessed by Brian McAvoy, has looked lively from the very start of this match. Philly Larkin having quite a battle with Johnny Pilkington. Here's Canis Brennan. Delivering it down towards Andy Comerford again. Michael Dignan once more. Trying to keep Brian McAvoy as quiet as possible. Kevin Keenahan from the Sir Kieran's Club in Clareen in Offaly. Of course, the colours they wear are the black and amber as well. Nice hand pass by Whelehan for Troy. John Troy's shot is over the bar, and there's only a point between the teams. A second point by John Troy. Well, that has certainly delighted the Offaly following. Only a point in it then, and the referee is holding up the match so that there can be attention given to Johnny Dooley. The selectors have a little confab on the side. This is that hand pass again, beautifully delivered inside for John Troy. It was a lovely sweet hurler. Over the bar that went. There was an accidental clash just before all of that, and there's a little gash on the forehead there of Johnny Dooley. Again, the medical officer called into action, and very wisely Dickie Murphy holding up the match, making sure that the player can receive proper attention. The biggest game of the year for all of these players, and in some of their cases the most important match they've ever played in their lives, those playing in it for the very first time. Johnny's been through it before. Who will ever forget 1994 in the last 5 minutes of that match against Limerick? Certainly they won't forget it in Limerick. Young and old having a look on here. 10 minutes from half-time. During half-time, of course, the crowd here will be watching the mini sevens games again. And one of Johnny's former colleagues has a daughter playing here. That's C. Fakeli, who's the daughter of Joachim. And she'll be playing at the mini sevens alongside Brenda Birmingham, former daughter of Brendan Birmingham, former star. Nicely picked up here again by McAvoy, who's a constant thorn. Hubert Rigney delivering it back there towards Billy Dooley against Willie O'Connor. The breaking ball here, and again that tower of strength, Pat O'Neill, comes forward, beating Brian Whelan to it, out as far as Cowan. Pat O'Neill is playing a very good, simple, effective game. At the other end, the other fullback, Kevin Keenahan, put under pressure by PJ Delaney. Charlie Carter is there as well. It comes back towards McAvoy. Ready to take on the Offaly defence. Looking for another one to open up the gap once more. And Brian McAvoy has now got 3 points in this match. He's having the kind of day that Fergie Toohey had here in 1995, and now it's 1-5 to 6 points. 2 points the margin. Given too much room, far too much latitude, dodging all the would-be tackles off his left side, a good score. Canis Brennan for once misses this one, and Philly Larkin is there to help out Peter Barry, his midfield partner, across towards Kenny O'Shea. Low ball inside towards DJ Carey. Carey has got 1 point in this match, that from a free. Here's PJ Delaney, little block at it by Kevin Keenahan. Keenahan does well. Can't get it away, however, because of the tightness of the marking there by the Cats forwards. Andy Comerford putting the head down, trying to go through. Nice ball outside. Here's a chance. Kenny O'Shea stopped there. Nicely put out. Out it comes towards Michael Dignan. Very good goalkeeping by Stephen Byrne once again. Out it goes towards Gary Hanafy. Canis Brennan. Hanafy coming forward. It's kicked back by Kavanagh in the end. Back towards his own fullback, Pat O'Neill. And there he is against Joe Dooley. Offaly get the verdict. Well, that was a very close call just seconds ago down at the other end as the ball is hurled in there. And once again, it's Pat O'Neill. Going very short this time to Liam Keown, who fortunately, from a Kilkenny point of view, got it up onto the stick. Kicks it towards Philly Larkin, 45 metres out. Beats Johnny Pilkington to it. Towards O'Shea once again, that's a good catch. Martin Hallamy discarding the red helmet, beaten on this occasion. Inside towards PJ Delaney, DJ Carey there as well. And here comes Kevin Martin, he's had a great year. Very near the sideline, in the end it becomes a Kilkenny sideline ball in this first ever All Leinster, All Ireland hurling final. Gary Hanafy yet to score. Hasn't really had much of a scoring chance so far. Michael Kavanagh from St. Lactans to hit this. Straight towards DJ Carey, that one went.
Come on, Carey!
Notice that Offaly are preparing a player on the far side. There could be a change there pretty soon. That's Martin Hanamy. Hanamy getting that ball out. Willie O'Connor coming across here to it. Philly Larkin. Down towards Kenny O'Shea, going low to try and take that one away was Johnny Pilkington, helped by Hanamy. Offaly get it back. The forwards needing a better service in there. Joe Dooley trying to make something of it. Brian Whelan coming onto it. This is a scoring chance for Whelan, and he puts it over the bar. That's a second point now for Brian Whelan, the first from a huge free from distance, and this one from play, making it 1-5 to 7 points. In other words, the margin is down once again to the minimum, and all as a result of this nice bit of play here by Brian Whelan, got away from his man, who is Liam Cohen, and put it over the bar. And it seems like we're going to have a change, and Marty will tell us about it.
Yes, indeed, Chair. Well, the Offaly selectors delayed selection because of Gary Hanafy's flu. Unfortunately, Gary Hanafy didn't really perform that well. He's been just taken off, and the man that's on is Paddy Mulhare.
So Mulhare in, and Mulhare operating at left half forward. It's Johnny Dooley has to thunder his way out now with a knee or a leg injury. He's been in the wars in the opening half hour of this particular match. Hoping that DJ, I'm sure, will really blossom as the game progresses, the faithful from Kilkenny against the faithful county from Offaly. So Brian Whelan, this free from just about a metre ahead of where he converted the earlier one. This is low, could have gone anywhere. Cohen has it. So with 5 minutes to go to half-time, it's Willie O'Connor who delivers a huge ball downfield. Andy Comerford trying to make it his. A stalemate situation. Finally knocked ahead by Philly Larkin towards PJ Delaney. And the referee, I think, will be forced to throw the ball up. So once again, some more news for Marty.
Kevin Fennelly has just switched DJ Carey to centre-half forward, Andy Comerford on the wing, but he did give the instruction, it was only just for a few minutes, to see if DJ were becoming more involved in the match.
That's Paddy Mulhare getting that ball forward towards the two-man full forward line. Joe Dooley and John Troy. Dooley going for the score. Lovely turn. And that's the equaliser. Level for the second time. Joe Dooley produces it again. A second point in this All-Ireland final, and it's 1-5 for Kilkenny. 8 points for Offaly. Well, there was speculation that this might well be Joe Dooley's last final. But if it is to be the case, he's certainly playing well. Taking his chances, just as he did against Clare 2 weeks ago. Dermody's puck out, a big one, down into the half back line. Rigney taking it. Oh, DJ Carey did really well to get that ball away. Can they now turn it into a score? Here's McAvoy. Good ball outside to Kenny O'Shea. Firing, and he puts it over the bar. Kenny O'Shea's first point. And Kilkenny have the lead again. Well, sometimes we don't see DJ doing all the donkey work, but he was doing it there. Very selfless work, on from McAvoy for Kenny O'Shea to put it over the bar. But it was the work of DJ Carey that set that one up. Lovely little flick away. Here's Tom Hickey. Tom operating at left half, left corner back. PJ Delaney across towards O'Shea with that ball carrying too much pace. Martin Hannemy racing after it. O'Shea trying to steal inside. Hanamy's a difficult carry to get that ball away from, and it's Kevin Martin in the end. Down to midfield towards Paddy Mulhare. Offaly have men there in numbers. Hubert Rigney, first touch, a good one. Sweeping it back into the two-man full forward line. Great catch by Pat O'Neill. Aware he was about to be hooked by Joe Dooley. Billy Dooley challenging as well. He's doing a lot of one-handed hurling in this particular match, Pat O'Neill. Comes back here to Willie O'Connor. That's a good ball forward to DJ Carey, who made that last point. And he's fouled, and it's a free in. DJ now operating on the 40 against Hubert Rigney. They keep on moving the players around, but the tactic clearly is to try and unsettle Hubert Rigney, who mops up an awful lot of ball for Offaly. So Dickie Murphy giving the decision. We're just under 2 minutes to go to half-time, possibly a little bit of injury time for the attention we had for Johnny Dooley. It'll be DJ to score this, Kilkenny's leading scorer in the championship. 3 goals and 18 points so far this year. From right in the middle of the field, the breeze against him. Will he opt to lob this ball in? Or will he go for the point himself? He's going for it, but it's stopped on the goal line by Stephen Byrne again. Outside to Simon Whelan. Charlie Carter in there to try and pinch it away from the corner back if at all possible. PJ Delaney, the hand pass back here to Brian McAvoy, lobbing it in, and again it's short, and again the goalkeeper gets it, and a quick counter-attack then by Offaly towards Joe Erity. Brian Whelan coming to try and take it away from Willie O'Connor. Liam Cohen's there to help the other defender. Cohen nicely down again. There's no marking of Brian McAvoy. Dignan standing back now, trying to challenge. Hubert Rigney next in with the challenges, and the referee says hang on, that's a foul, and it's a free in for Kilkenny. Great work being done by Brian McAvoy in this first half. DJ Carey calling for a replacement stick. So close to half time now. Kilkenny looking to stretch their lead here to 2 points. It'll be DJ Carey who will take it, as Brian McAvoy has been one of the stars of the first half for the Kilkenny Cats, looking for their 26th All-Ireland victory. That would put them within one of Cork. DJ taking maximum care over this. There's some jeering up on the hill among the Offaly fans, trying to put him off his stride. But they certainly haven't put him off his stride, and he puts it over the bar. DJ Carey's second point at free. She's happy, they're all happy in there among the Kilkenny following, because they've got a 2 point lead, 1-7 to 8 points. And in this first half so far, Offaly have created more chances. They've created 17 chances to Kilkenny's 13. But that goal after 11 minutes by Charlie Carter, so important. Michael Kavanagh gets it down to Philly Larkin, busy as always at midfield. Two players chasing after him. Billy Dooley was one of them, not quite sure where that was going to end up. And here once again is Brian McAvoy. John Troy trying to dispossess him. He gets it out to Liam Cohen. Great block down by Michael Dignan this time. Running into Peter Barry, however. DJ Carey, it's a lovely pick up ahead of Johnny Dooley. That was wonderful hurling. Now where's this going to end? Short again is the answer. Stephen Byrne once more. Last line of defence. The ball has dropped into his hands on about three occasions in the last 10 minutes. It was a lovely pickup. He's got a hand injury, as you can see, but the pickup of DJ Carey was as sweet as you could see. Charlie Carter to leave this one, and it's going to be Brian McAvoy, happy with his 3 points from play in the first half. Sideline cut, not a particularly good one, straight to Michael Dignan, and the referee blows the whistle for half-time here in the 110th All-Ireland Hurling Final, the Guinness All-Ireland Championship reaching its climax. Kevin Martin did a steady job at left half-back, but it was Brian McAvoy who was one of the real stars for Kilkenny, and Charlie Carter who got the goal, his only chance, after 11 minutes. There are 2 points separating the teams at half-time, but Kilkenny have the vital lead by 1-7 to 8 points. And we're going down to the sideline once again to Marty Morrissey.
Coach Mulhair, despite that Charlie Carter's goal, you fought back very well.
Well, we came back. We didn't start off very well. The last 10 minutes we have come into the game a bit all right, but we have it all to do in the second half hour. Kilkenny have seemed to be more fresher than us at the moment.
Explain the switch of Brian Whelan to the attack.
Well, we felt that Brian was labouring a bit wing back, and McAvoy was very fast, so we just thought that it would give Brian a break there for a few minutes.
McAvoy is still causing you problems.
He scored 3 points so far, yeah. But like, all the team is causing problems at the moment. But we're still only 2 points behind.
Well, here, well done, thank you.
2 points in it on the scoreboard, very little though in it in terms of the trend of the play in that first half. I'll be talking to Cyril Farrell and Tomás Mulcahy about what they thought of that 35 minutes of hurling after this commercial break.
Standard Life. Enjoy a better standard of living.
No one offers you more coverage than ESAP Digiphone. ESAP Digiphone, making it work for you.
For exceptional quality, incredible service and guaranteed better prices, you must visit Tubbs & Tiles, Ireland's premier tile, bathroom and wood floor showrooms nationwide. From award-winning cooked ham and delicatessen meat products to pre-pack ready meals for quality and service, make Carol Meats your number one.
Travel Letterkenny to Dublin in comfort from just £8 day return. You're better off on Bus Éireann.
Introducing new Advil Ibuprofen. Clinical tests for non-prescription medicine show nothing is proven to work better on pain. Nothing. Advil, advanced medicine for pain.
In any game, there's only one winner. Berger Paints. Looking good. Lasting longer.
Chocolates, 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 Cadbury's, chocolates, Cadbury's, chocolates, chocolates.
You can pay your household bills the next time you're in your local post office. With Bill Pay, it's simple, quick, and there's no charge. Bill Pay at the post office.
Feel the energy. Adidas.
The Wedgetarian.
The Wedgehead.
The King of Vegetables.
The Meat and Two Wedge Man.
They're back, so wedge out again at McDonald's. Golden crunchy potato wedges with a choice of sour cream and chive dip. A new tomato and chili dip for a limited time.
Shopping in SuperValue doesn't just mean the freshest of fresh foods.
You get refreshingly low prices too.
Super savings at SuperValue. Like new SuperValue Petit Fromage Frais 6-pack, only 89p. SuperValue Cheese Singles 20-pack, an amazing £1.09. SuperValue Orange Juice 4-pack, just £2.49. Refreshing savings every day at SuperValue.
That's shopping, as it should be.
The referee looks at his watch. It's all over.
For all that matters in Gaelic games.
The way I look at Gaelic games, if you turn around for maybe 30 seconds, you could miss an awful lot.
Relive the excitement of the GAA Championship season. Tomorrow, only in The Star.
Down on the pitch at Croke Park, the Artain Boys Band entertain the crowd. They've been joined by tenor Paul Hennessy. He's just given the crowd a version of the Rose of Moon Coin. The Offaly Rover will be up next. However, back here at the panel to Moss Mulcahy. Cyril Farrell made a comment to me during that first half that Kilkenny were living on scraps and they're leading at half time.
That's right, and I suppose they've gone in a half time. They'll be very happy to be leading by 2 points. But I think if I was Kevin Felly inside now, I'd be saying to his half forwards, our full forward line, have the beating of these Offaly backs. Your half forwards, keep the ball going. No matter what way it comes, lift the ball, go on the ground, left and right, especially Andy Comfort. Don't be holding up the ball up the middle of the park. But certainly in that first half, they lost their way in the half forward line, and apart from right back to right. And in midfield, they struggled. Peter Barry is finding it hard to come to towns in the middle of the park as well. So. But inside, they seem to have great potential in Ken O'Shea, Charlie Carter and PJ Delaney. And if they get enough possession, I think they'll win this match.
Cyril Farrell, Offaly this afternoon, was scoring those nice direct kind of points that has become a hallmark of them this championship.
Here's Joe Dooley here again. Well battled down by Tom Hickey, but again, he makes an angle and over his right shoulder, over the bar. Again, he shows his ensemble. But like, Tom Hickey did nothing wrong, but Jesse just got a bit of space and great point. And he's back on song again today, and all the Offaly sports will be happy for that. Any chance he gets, you know, he's scoring, but they're shooting a lot from out the field and they're going wide from outside.
Scores like that, Joe Erity got another one, Michael Dighton got another one, direct scores are fine scores to get. But Tomás Mulcahy, when you concede a goal then, like they did to Charlie Carter, it undoes everything.
That's right, and it comes from a long puck from Joe Dougherty, and as the ball breaks aside, watch Charlie Carter, he's very quick to react to the breaking ball, pushes it forward, his first touch lets him down, he doesn't actually flick it, get it up. But it's a great lesson for a forward, when the ball breaks around the square like that, you must let it go, and it's a great shot from the left-hand side across to the far side of the goal.
Here's another chance here coming up. You're going to see a great ball here. O'Shea lets the ball go hard across the square here. Kevin Mann gets touched. Falls into Delaney. Great shot with Brian Whelan. What a hurler this guy is. Saves a certain goal and clears it out. It would have been back in net. It would have been curtains that time. And after a while, you see Whelan going up front and scoring two great points as well. And again, what can you say about this Stephen Byrne as well, Michael? You know, again, he's held awfully in the game today again, some fantastic saves when Kilkenny seemed to be through for goals.
Yeah, I mean, he made a save in this, Cyril, that really, again, it's hallmark of his play in the Championship this year.
Here's Comfort, gives a good ball into O'Shea again, goes a good bit of running and blasts a hard shot. But there's Byrne again. Not only does he block it, but he flicks it away as well. Like, and he's done that all the season. I suppose you'll have to say that he's a find of the year as regards goalkeepers.
Without Stephen Byrne, situations like that, Tomás, would have Offaly in real trouble, not just today, but obviously other days as well.
Yeah, and
they wouldn't be here on another day.
Exactly, and at the other end, they've missed a few chances themselves. I mean, they've more of the scoring chances. They just seem to be shooting a lot under pressure and shooting from a long way out, you know, and they're playing the tactic of maybe pinning Johnny Dooley out in the middle of the park and leaving maybe two men inside. But when you're hitting balls from 70 yards wide, it's very frustrating for your two inside forwards. In situations like that, you've seen Kilkenny at the other end pushing the ball in low, in front of their full forwards, and it's paid dividends. They got the goal in the first half.
It's a game, Cyril, that is difficult to kind of fully read the trend in it.
Yeah, well, like Kilkenny will be in at halftime, I suppose, happy enough, but Offaly won't be too perturbed either. Okay, they won't want to be down. But like that breeze, while it's with Kilkenny second, it's not favouring anyone, as you can see by the minor match. And definitely Kilkenny around the middle of the field. Okay, like Larkin's getting a good bit of ball, but Barry's getting well beaten, and any comfort, the half forward line, except for McAvoy, they're not shifting ball in. Now, Offaly have got a lot of possession, but they haven't scored over. But Finnelly be saying to the fellas, look, get enough ball in, pump it in, and we'll win this match. But they have to pick it up around the midfield. You'll probably see it at halftime again, even though DJ went in centre forward. You'll probably see Comfort going in centre again and DJ wing forward. But I suppose the biggest talking point at halftime will be in the Offaly camp to see that Brian Whelan's gone up front. Yeah. But Brian's such a good hurler, you could play him anywhere. He's got two fantastic scores, and like he's a man for all seasons, really.
Let's get another view of this particular final. Let's go down pitch side to Marty Morrissey.
Well, joining me now, Michael, is former Galway star Pete Finnerty. From where you saw the game, what's your thoughts on it so far?
Firstly, it has been a great competitive game of hurling, and it is to'd and fro'd. Kilkenny went well early on, Offaly seemed to come back into it, Kilkenny back into it again, and Offaly back into it. But looking on the half, you'd have to say that Kilkenny were the better team. Their forwards looked that little bit sharper. Thomas Brennan is going well at centre-back, and with Brian Whelan locking from the forwards, Offaly have a lot of work to do in the second half. But knowing Offaly and the way the wind is brought, it seems to be favouring them, so they still could come through.
Well, the word is now filtering through that Brian Whelan has had the flu over the last 24 hours or so. Brian McAvoy is a real potential match winner, though.
He is. Brian Whelan was struggling early on in the first half, and he had the flu. He went to bed early last night, and you could see he didn't have the energy to stay with McAvoy. McAvoy got his confidence up early on, and he's going very well. Ken O'Shea is coming into the game. DJ came out to midfield there and gathered a few balls late in the second half, and with Charlie Carter poaching around the square, he'll score his goals. Stephen Byrne came to the rescue there against Ken O'Shea as well. Offaly, on the other hand, John Troy has got a few balls at centre forward, but Cam Sprint is still clearing a lot, and they have to get more of a unit working together.
Now, it's very, very windy down here. It's a real swirlwind as such. But despite that conditions, who are you going for now?
I'm still going for Offaly. I still think that Offaly will come through. And it's difficult to see it at the moment because Kilkenny are going better. But it's at the last 10 minutes that you have to be going well. And I think that Offaly may lift it for the last 10 minutes and come through.
Finity, thank you.
Yeah, there's a man there, Brian McAvoy, who will be very happy with his performance in the first half. Offaly coming back out onto the pitch. Let's quickly get a final word from the panel. Tomás Mulcahy, you went for Kilkenny at the beginning. I presume you're sticking with that.
Yeah, I'm sticking with it. I mean, I'd expect a big challenge from Offaly in the second half, especially in their forward division, full forward line. But I can see if there's enough possession going to the inside line, they will create more scoring chances and maybe get another one or two goals. So I'm going to stick with Kilkenny.
OK, let's go back to Ger Canning.
Yes, Michael, something strange has happened here this afternoon. I think the wind has changed direction since the start of the game. And by the flags across the far side, it's now blowing down the field towards Hill 16. In other words, it's favouring Offaly yet again as the second half gets underway. And I had that little whisper as well at half-time that the great Brian Whelan did wake up this morning with a bout of flu, and that might have explained his performance during the first half or at periods during the first half. Offaly coming, looking for the first score of the second half. John Troy trying to make some inroads there, but he picked the ball off the ground, and it's going to be a free out for Kilkenny. This, once again, here is what was happening as they were trying to launch an attack, and the ball there was picked up off the ground. Brian Whelan now, by the way, has gone into full forward in a complete transformation as DJ Carey sets up. Andy Comer hits it low. Stephen Byrne makes the save. Tricky one down there because of the state of the pitch this afternoon. out to Johnny Pilkington. Beautifully caught by Philly Larkin. Setting it up once again for Brian McAvoy. And that has gone wide. That's just the second wide in this match for Kilkenny. Obviously, they had just one in the first half, and six in the first half was the Offaly return. Stephen Byrne playing in his eighth championship match. Johnny Dooley contesting, but beaten for it here by Peter Barry. Kevin Martin picking it up. Dropping it down towards John Troy. Getting there ahead of him, however, is Tom Hickey, but he was out over the sideline. And Sean McMahon, the linesman from Clare, was waving his flag furiously. A young player who's had a dream year so far, Tom Hickey, hoping that he'll be taking the Liam McCarthy Cup at the end of the 70 minutes. Troy going short this time, inside towards Brian Whelihan. Now it's full forward, and that's over the bar. It might well transform Offaly yet. So, just a point between the teams. In front of an attendance today of 65,491. This is what they saw, and that's where it ended up. Joe Dermody. Seems to be pucking into the wind. But the more flags you look at here, you realise the wind is swirling around quite a lot. That's Joe Erity trying to get that ball down to the other Joe, Joe Dooley. Out towards Paddy Mulhare. Quick change of direction in order for Paddy to take it on and try and take it by Michael Kavanagh. And the referee's whistle sounds. Michael Kavanagh. Paddy Mulhare, who's hoping to really get more and more into this match. It'll be a free to Offaly for that foul by Kavanagh. John Troy coming out to take it. Just inside that 45-metre line. This to level the match. Rolling it up confidently, hitting it sweetly, or so it seems. No, it's just tailed away in the last minute. Seemed to be on its way. But he's put it wide, and there's still a point between the teams. Kilkenny still the leaders. Tense faces down there among the Offaly substitutes. Dermody hits it right through the centre towards PJ Delaney. It runs on beyond him. Charlie Carter has it. Shortens the grip on the stick, and he puts it over the bar. A goal and a point now by Charlie. Kilkenny's first point of the second half, and it's as you were at half time with 2 points between the teams. But it was a huge puck out that time, all the way down to Charlie Carter and over the bar. And the flags on the far side right now would seem to indicate that the breeze has changed direction yet again, and it's now blowing down towards the canal end. In other words, it's favouring Kilkenny. And Canis Brennan here knew he was going to be hooked. This time he was blocked down by Johnny Dooley. Peter Barry trying to make some inroads. Billy Dooley there as well had a goal chance right at the start of the match. Kevin Keenahan's come out trying to make amends for that goal that Charlie Carter got. Out to Johnny Pilkington. Pilkington racing through, stopped by Willie O'Connor, but the referee says foul blow, however, and it's going to be a free for Offaly. Well, a fair bit of dash and courage shown by Johnny Pilkington, but he was fouled by Willie O'Connor. This is how it all happened. Referee says dangerous play, and that's going to be a free in. Free taken by Brian Whelihan, and duly put over the bar. 4 points now by Brian Whelihan. So it's 11 points to 10 effectively. Darmody giving the signal. Another huge one booming downfield beyond DJ Carey. Simon Whelihan going very low, challenged by Charlie Carter, kicked ahead towards Kenny O'Shea. Stopped here by Michael Dignan. Johnny Pilkington low along the ground, beyond Paddy Mulhare. Dennis Brennan getting it out as far as Tom Hickey, Kilkenny's captain. Awfully there in numbers. Johnny Pilkington doing a lot of good spade work. Hubert Rigney getting away from the challenge of DJ Carey. Pat O'Neill is having a storming match once again for Kilkenny. towards Kenny O'Shea, stopped by Martin Hanamy. Hand passing it to Mulhair. Loose player inside is Brian Whelan, and Tom Hickey just got it away, but only as far as John Troy. Here's another chance for Offaly, and John Troy has put it wide, and they're in there protesting. Brian Whelan is certainly in there protesting. A disputed shot and a disputed score, as it were, and Brian Whelan still furiously arguing with the two umpires. Just for a moment, he was left unmarked, and Tom Hickey did really well to take it away, but it fell to John Troy. Hubert Rigney moving back to try and take it, flipped away from him by DJ Carey, doing a lot of very good work that's pretty well going unnoticed. This time he's the provider to Charlie Carter. Nice turn inside, trying to get it back towards DJ, catches it well, trying to take it out of the defence. Hubert Rigney's there, so too is Johnny Poulton, and it comes out to Andy Comerford, blocked down by Kevin Martin. Back to Comerford once again, very awkward angle, second great block down by Kevin Martin. Now it's Charlie Carter. Simon Whelan with another block, three in a row from two Offaly backs, really fired up, trying to play the game of their life. It means so much for amateur players to take home the cup. This was a wonderful spell of play. Kevin Martin first doing the blocking, and this time it's Simon Whelan. Comerford with the sideline ball, in towards DJ Carey, trying to skip away from Whelan. McAvoy coming in on this left-hand side. An awkward one for him, and he's put it outside and he's put it wide. So that's the second wide of the second half now from a Kilkenny point of view. And that gentleman there sees himself up on the screen, but he's a disappointed man. Still, his side are a point ahead. I'm sure that man felt they should be two ahead. Tremendous noise, great excitement as well. Canis Brennan. Again, blocked down by John Troy. Comes to Joe Dooley. Blocked again by Canis Brennan. Well, the blocking in the early phase of the second half by players on both sides has been exemplary. Paddy Mulhair. As we watch this once again, Joe Dooley. And again, a courageous bit of play by Brennan. So Mulhair to hit it. Goes all the way in towards Brian Wheeler. Have been marked by Tom Hickey. And he's gone down injured, and it's going to be a free in for Offaly, and a chance of the equaliser. So let's go across to the sideline just before the free is taken to Marty.
Well, just down at the other end of the field, a very astute positional switch has been made by Kevin Fennelly and his co-selectors. DJ Carey has been moved in now full forward, and PJ Delaney is now playing on the 40.
Well, Brian Whelan seems to have done that right ankle. John Troy to hit this, should be the equaliser. And he's put it over. A third point by John Troy. And the sides are level in this All-Ireland final for the third time. It's Kilkenny 1-8, Offaly 11 points. You see from the flags there the breeze, and that breeze right now does seem to be favouring Offaly, but it swirls and it changes direction so many times, it's very deceptive. Kevin Martin out towards Johnny Dooley. Johnny trying to press forward there. Johnny Pilkington alongside him. PJ Delaney, and he's gone down, and the referee says there's a foul by Kevin Martin, who argues that he was using his shoulder fairly. Dickie Murphy didn't see it that way. Always the referee will have a quiet little word with the player, diffuses everything. Players have so much respect for him. And PJ Delaney, who earned that free, watching now as DJ Carey will hit. Can Kilkenny go back in front again? The distance from the goal is about 48 metres. DJ's got two so far out of three frees. They look at it and he's put it over. So a third point by DJ Carey, and Kilkenny have a 1 point lead. And look at that for wonderful colour and wonderful excitement on one of the sporting days of the year. Stephen Burns puck out. Cohen kind of get under the ball. It's a fabulous catch by Liam Cohen. Joe Dooley was in there trying to make life awkward for him. It comes out to Johnny Pilkington. inside towards Brian Whelan, happily recovered from injury. Pat O'Neill is the man he was trying to take on, and the referee is whistling again. Whelan gets his free, and again this should be the equaliser. Well, said to have come into the match with a bout of flu, already damaging a right ankle. Michael Bond looking on. Whelan strikes it, and strikes it inch perfect. 5 points now by Brian Whelan, and they're level once again, now for the fourth time. That's quite a switch, but they did try it, of course, in one of the Clare matches. Towards Brian McAvoy's wing, because of his good performance in the first half, you can be sure they'll try and favour him time and again. Kenny O'Shea has switched wings, crossover there towards Charlie Carter, good defending by Simon Whelan, and eventually they force that ball away. Peter Barry trying to keep it away from Paddy Mulhare. Johnny Dooley is in there to offer assistance, and at the end of the pile-up it's going to be a throw ball between two players. Dickie Murphy forced into that particular course of action for about the third or fourth time. Pitch is incredibly soft, you see that divot there. As Andy Comerford comes forward, beating a couple of Offaly men for pace, kicking it in the end, and he's kicked it to the left, and he's kicked it wide. He had a real chance. I think he was well aware that he was going to be hooked, but he showed great pace to get in that time. Well, even when the ball goes wide, you see on the screen there the happy faces of so many people here in an attendance of over 55,000 people. Pressure applied once again here. Joe Erity this time. Erity going in like a train, but a steamroll his way through, and he scored! It's a goal for Offaly! Into the second half, Offaly go in front. Well, he has a fabulous record of scoring goals in the Championship. He's only ever scored 1 point, that was 2 weeks ago, but this now is the sixth goal that Joe Erity has scored in Championship hurling, and what a vital one it is. Back live, coming through the centre there once again like a steamroller is Michael Dagenham, downfield towards Brian Whelan. Lovely control, he's 45 metres out, taking on Michael Kavanagh. Trying to link up beside here with Paddy Mulhare. Kavanagh gets it forward, however. The man who's full-back on the under-21 team this year, John Troy, one-handed by Whelan, stealing it away beautifully to Erity. Really taking on Canis Brennan and trying to limit his effectiveness. Good hand pass from Troy, out to Johnny Dooley. They go for another score. Bounces in front of Joe Dermody. Happy that there was nobody coming in, so he had the chance to be absolutely certain in his handling. Simon Whelan, what a wonderful catch. Well, the range of skills we are seeing in this match this afternoon, very, very impressive. Liam Cohen hurling well towards DJ Carey, can't take it down. Charlie Carter can. 45 metres out, Charlie. Oh, he wanted a rapid response to that goal by Joe Erity. But it's Offaly who lead by 3 points. This is another look from behind the Offaly, or behind the Kilkenny goal, of the Offaly move by Joe Erity, coming in powerfully so, and a wonderful shot. That was from a pencil camera back behind the goal. This is Joe Erity in full flight once again, confidence high, and he's scored another one over the bar. A goal now and 2 points for Joe Erity. All the distinguished guests here are looking on. I'm sure there's thoughts in their minds about what a spectacular game it can be from time to time. As Joe Dermody pucks out across towards Kenny O'Shea's wing. Andy Comerford picking it up. Hooked well. Johnny Pilkington was in there trying to make life very difficult for the Kilkenny number 11, and it ends up being a 65. Went off the back, and that's the very first Kilkenny taking the opportunity to prepare perhaps a fresh man to come in. Pat O'Neill is coming up to take the 65. We'll see from the breeze behind on the flag there that the wind is behind them at this stage. It's a huge one, but it's gone to the right. So Pat makes his way back onto the full back line. The man he's marking during the second half is Brian Whelan. Score of 5 points, most of them from frees. Stephen Byrne about to puck out. Everybody under it. Paddy Mulhare taking it down. Canis Brennan there beside him. Every challenge is entered into as if their very lives depend upon winning this particular tie. Most important match of the year for all of them. Kenny O'Shea here taking his chance. Martin Hanamy's after him. He hits it and he hits it well. That's 2 points now in this match for Ken O'Shea. He'll be delighted. They're absolutely thrilled. Three between them once again. Great individual work here by Kenny O'Shea, making the opening for himself. And from another angle, you can see that he shrugged off the attentions of the Offaly backs to make that score. Killen, left half back. Of course, the man in the corner who's beaten for it by Simon Whelan. Michael Dignan into the centre towards Johnny Dooley. Dooley against Barry, that's quite a battle this afternoon. Kevin Martin was coming in to try and get that ball forward. Andy Comerford has it. Kilkenny needing opportunities to try and convert those opportunities into scores, but nothing on this occasion. Just had a picture, DJ Carey at full forward having a little look back at the man who was playing the ball in. So you just wonder what the Kilkenny management can come up with in terms of freshening up the ideas. DJ now at full forward where he's been marked by Kevin Keenahan. John Troy. Hickey doing well. Forward there by Peter Barry. PJ Delaney this time trying to dispossess Kevin Martin. That goal has really changed things for Offaly. And they come looking for more. Pat O'Neill just kept it away from Brian Whelan. Needed Willie O'Connor to get it out, however. Philly Larkin. This is O'Neill once again. Drop hitting this one into the centre. Peter Barry first to react. Kilkenny looking fresh. Beyond Charlie Carter this time, and it favours the cornerback the whole time, Simon Whelan. Good work by Charlie Carter, but he's put the ball out over the end line. Kenny O'Shea is right corner forward at this stage. DJ Carey full forward. This man here, Charlie Carter, remains at top of the left. Their half forward line reads PJ Delaney, Andy Comerford, and also, of course, Brian McAvoy. Midway now through the second half. Canis Brennan for a Kilkenny side trailing by 3 points. Simon Whelan again getting out there first, and this time Charlie Carter came to have done the driving. Simon Whelan playing a very good second half. Offaly then, the side beaten in the Leinster final by Kilkenny. 3 points ahead, and a nice gesture there as the manager of one team offers water to a player on the other. It's part of the spirit in which this match has been played. That's nicely forward by Joe Dooley, kicking it inside here. This is Paddy Mulhare, and strong, forceful work once again. Pat O'Neill knocking it well away from danger. DJ Carey now has gone into the centre of the field. There's just one man up front, and that's Charlie Carter. Kenny O'Shea with a quizzical expression on his face. Referee's been having words with him, just telling him to cool it down a little bit. Johnny Pilkington here upended unceremoniously. Now I'm sure Johnny and Hubert Wigney wondering whether it'll be a history-making day for them, beaten in the Leinster final, but will they take the cup at the end of it all? Rigney has hit this one to the right. No real chance there for the Offaly forwards to profit. DJ Carey is now right half forward in a switch with PJ Delaney. Delaney now full forward. Andy Comerford just got a touch on that one. Coming in here is McAvoy, looking for another score. Nice ball inside. And what's the referee going to do here? Because there's a player upended. The referee is calling aside Martin Hanamy. Once there was a real hint of danger, Hanamy forced into taking the player down. PJ Delaney, the player in question. And so Martin Hanamy becomes the first player to have his name taken in the 1998 Guinness All-Ireland Hurling Final. This is the reason why. And it's a penalty. It had to be. So three men will be on the goal line. Martin Hanamy will be one of them. Stephen Byrne is there as well. Kevin Martin's coming out, and they're waiting to bring Brian Whelan all the way up from full forward. Is he going to be the one on the goal line? They've only two there at the moment. They're still having a consultation. It's Whelan who's going in. DJ Carey to take it. How often in the past has he got important goals in major matches? Remember the two he got from frees, from ordinary 20-metre frees in the Leinster final this year. Kilkenny trail by 3 points. Will this be the equaliser by DJ Carey? He's put it over the bar. A fourth point by DJ Carey, and so they remain 2 points adrift. Well, this is interesting. He put it over the bar. I have an idea he probably almost certainly went for a goal. And Marty Morrissey has some more news.
While DJ Carey was taking that penalty, there's Johnny Dooley was called over to the sideline to talk to the Pat McLaughlin and Páirc Mulhere, the two Offaly selectors. And Páirc Mulhere has now gone down to Michael Bond because there is concern whether or not Johnny Dooley can continue.
We also got a view there of Niall Maloney, who could very well be coming in pretty soon for Kilkenny. This is Johnny Dooley, about whom there is some concern, and that's saved again by Joe Dermody. Offaly leading still by those 2 points. In terms of time remaining, about 11 and a half minutes to go. Joe Dooley has it. Still Dooley going forward, in towards John Troy, saved by Joe Dermody. Very good interception there, and a fine clearance down towards DJ Carey. Kenny O'Shea and Philly Larkin in after it. Johnny Poulton trying to get that ball again downfield in towards his forwards. Liam Keown fast at the ball this time. Stopped by Johnny Dooley, but there's support there. Nicely out of defence. Charlie Carter keeping it away here from Martin Hanamy. Delivering a dangerous ball in there. Stephen Byrne making the save. Kenny O'Shea very nearly got a little flick on that one. It's up and down the field. Championship hurling. The prize, a huge one. Brian Whelan again. Pat O'Neill in there to try and make life more awkward for him. A partial block on it. Tom Hickey getting the clearance in. Into the middle of the field. Johnny Pilkington beaten by two men. Brian McAvoy and Andy Comerford. Comerford firing it forward, but that'll favour Kevin Martin against DJ Carey. Just not the kind of direct pass that DJ was looking for. This is a fine catch by Billy Dooley. Out around the middle of the field at this stage. Liam Keown. Offaly just with their noses in front. Towards John Troy. Canis Brennan. Oh, stopped by Paddy Mulhere when he was trying to pick out one of the half forwards with the pass. Towards Joe Dooley. Great catch again by Pat O'Neill. If it's an All-Ireland final and Kilkenny were involved in the 90s, you can be sure that Pat O'Neill will turn in a storming performance. And that he's done again this afternoon. Martin Hanamy. Breaks out to Paddy Mulhere. Peter Barry, assisted by Charlie Carter. Towards PJ Delaney, got a little touch to give it away from Hubert Brigney onto Andy Comerford. Kilkenny raiding again, trying to plug back the lead. And that's a foul on Kevin Keenahan. And Kilkenny are about to make a change as anticipated. And let's get some news of that from Marty.
Well, Niall Maloney is being introduced, and the man that's going to be coming off is Ken O'Shea. Offaly seem to have lots of problems at the moment. Darren Hanafy has been given the slip of paper. We anticipated it was for Johnny Dooley, but that in turn could change now.
So Gary, or Darren Hanafy rather, brother of Gary of course, he is now on the field. Well, on the field and off the field. Selectors just waiting to make their move. Billy Dooley, the injured player here. And Offaly, I think, being forced into making a change. They might have been considering another player going off, but it looks bad for Billy Dooley as we go back for Marty.
Yes, well, Tony Murphy, the Offaly Hurling Board Secretary, had to change the name on the slip of paper. It was going to be Johnny Dooley, but now it has to be Johnny's brother, Billy.
So Darren Hanafy gets his big chance. There are just about 8 minutes to go. Right in there it goes. Brian Whelan, lovely dancing movement from him, and he gets it over the bar. A wonderful halfback, running his best form, now proving himself to be a very accurate and astute forward with his sixth point of the day. Delight for Offaly fans. He's had six chances to score, you know, in this match, and he's got 6 points. Johnny Pilkington firing it in. It's gone over the bar. Two in a row. Pilkington's first point. This match far from being over. 4 points separating the teams, but Offaly with a couple of good scores in the last few seconds. This is nicely taken down by Philly Larkin. Now it's Kilkenny's turn to attack. They need a score badly. And Philly Larkin provides his first point of the day. So 3 points the margin, 115 to 112. This was a beautiful skill just moments ago here from Philly Larkin, beautifully over the bar. Stephen Byrne, man who saved Offaly on many occasions during this championship season. Towards Joe Dooley, runs on towards John Troy, away by Hickey, out to Paddy Mulhare. Well, it was always going left from the time it left his stick. A look of agony in his face, and Billy Dooley really feeling the pain of all of this. And you can see that he's damaged the knee. A highly pressurised occasion. Once again, McAvoy advancing. PJ Delaney trying to get it through. Delaney hits it, it's stopped. The referee has whistled. It's in the net, it's not going to count. The referee's whistle has definitely sounded before all of that. Dickie Murphy with a look at the watch. 6 minutes remaining. Here in Croke Park, they were ready to change the score as PJ Delaney fired that one in there, buried in the end. Niall Maloney's goal, however, does not count, and it's going to be a free in for Kilkenny just as soon as play resumes. And some more news from the sideline.
Indeed, Kilkenny are making lots of changes. We can tell you that John Costello is going to be coming in for Michael Kavanagh, but we also see that Sean Ryan has been given another slip of paper, and he is normally playing in the attack.
So two changes for the price of one, as it were, late in the match. Concern everywhere. DJ Carey stepping up to take this one. And you know what that can mean many, many times. It means a score this time. It's a point. The man who also got a point from the penalty. I'm almost certain he went for a goal. But 2 points between the teams. And DJ Carey has now got 5 points. All too early yet to be making predictions as to who's going to take the Liam McCarthy Cup, because anything can happen. Remember 1994? Remember all those other years as well, with late, valuable and vital scores. Billy Larkin up towards PJ Delaney. Plenty of changes being made. Kevin Martin stopping this one initially. DJ Carey trying to roll it up onto the stick. Having difficulty. Normally a skill he'd have done in about 2 seconds, but the pitch is so terribly soft this afternoon following the heavy overnight rain. Philly Larkin driving it in, stopped by Byrne. Stephen Byrne is challenged there by Niall Maloney, still gets his clearance in. Swept up here by Brian McAvoy for such a good first half. Michael Dignan now, his side leading by just 2 points. Pat O'Neill appeared to be dragged back that time, pressured by Brian Whelan. Canis Brennan trying to get it away for the Cats, beating the block there of Darren Hanafy. Philly Larkin firing it forward again towards anybody who will do this. It's Niall Maloney was there along with DJ Carey, not Charlie Carter. Great block down by Simon Whelan. Carter this time dispossessed by Paddy Mulhair. Offaly still with their noses ahead, but just about. Kilkenny coming back to Canis Brennan. Mulhair rising for this one, taking it down well. Charlie Carter then going in, doing his little bit of defending as a forward. Peter Barry after this. Simon Whelan put everything he had after that. It's Joe Dooley who turns it back downfield. Brian Whelan chases. Canis Brennan's after it as well, facing his own goal. And he gets it away from Brian Whelan. Brennan's had a very, very steady game for Kilkenny. And it appears that Andy Comerford has gone. He's left the game and been replaced by Sean Ryan. Sean Ryan, former minor and under 21 star, now part of the action. Kilkenny having to freshen up their side. Just about 3 minutes remain. Simon Whelan in no particular hurry. At the end of the two-year experimental phase, the backdoor system, the team that got in by that backdoor have got a lead. Ken O'Shea and it's John Costner, rather, who's come in place of Michael Kavanagh. That's another switch that they have just made. Also notice there that John Ryan has come in place of Johnny Dooley for Offaly. So lots of changes and switches very, very late in the match as both teams try to turn it their way. John Troy nicely on towards John Ryan. Nicely in here towards Erity, the man who got the goal earlier on. Coming forward again, missing it this time. And it's a goal! Brian Whelan has done it! Brian Whelan has made it 2:15 to 1:13 with 2 minutes to go. It was Joe Erity who was steaming forward again, taking on Peter Barry, missing his shot. It came to Whelan, and he buried it past Joe Dermody. Offaly will never have a better chance of taking the Liam McCarthy Cup than they have right now. Bidding to win the title for the fourth time ever. Pat O'Neill getting that ball away towards Brian McAvoy. Everybody chasing after him. This is Liam Killen. 5 points separate the teams. Nicely held back there. Hubert Rigney. So many heroes on both teams this afternoon. John Troy here going forward again. Leaving one inside here. Here's a late chance. And it's stopped. It was Hanavy who had the chance. Dermody making the block. Still on the goal line there. Tom Hickey getting it away for Kilkenny. Well, it really would have been absolute curtains at that stage for the Kilkenny Cats. Martin Hanamy with a minute to go. Pat O'Neill losing the helmet, injured as well, but still got that ball away. Michael Dignan coming out here. That switch worked well. Dignan tearing through the heart of the Kilkenny defence on his left-hand side, and he puts it over the bar. The arms in triumph. Surely now it's Offaly. Dignan's second point. Offaly, who won the All-Ireland for the first time ever in 1981. Did it again, of course, in 1985. Did it in 1994 against Limerick. And now they're about to do it against one of the big powers in senior hurling. Hickey making the catch. 6 points the difference. Almost into injury time. Offaly stand firm. Kevin Martin having another great game at left half back. Willie O'Connor. Kilkenny needing a few extra minutes and a few goals quickly. Philly Larkin has it. They've already lost the minor this afternoon, and right now they look like they're about to lose the senior. And Joe Dooley looks like he's about to win his third medal in the All-Ireland series. Philly Larkin hits it in. It's stopped by Simon Whelan. Driven way downfield again towards John Ryan. Good work again by Canis Brennan. John Ryan, the number 21 in there, alongside Brian Whelan. He has had a wonderful match once again after a shaky start when Brian McAvoy got in for a few early scores. The switch has worked well. And Michael Bond, the man from Galway, who came in late in the season, looks to be on the verge of an All-Ireland success. Mulhair has Kevin Martin there to assist him. Look at the liveliness now in the Offaly play. They look fresher. back down again. Hubert Rigney, it's all over, and Offaly are the All Ireland Hurling Champions from 1998. Hubert Rigney, the captain, will take the Liam McCarthy Cup back down to the Midlands. But this time it'll be to Offaly. Michael Bond, one of the heroes, the man who came in, who turned around their season. But Offaly had so many heroes this afternoon. And the final score here shows Offaly winning by 6 points. It's Offaly 2 goals and 16 points. Kilkenny 1 goal and 13. Here's Marty.
Michael Bond, you certainly transformed this Offaly team since you came in.
I didn't do anything to this team. They were there all along, Marty, and they're a fabulous team. And what a wonderful day for Offaly and Offaly Hurling. And I'd like to thank each and every one of the players, all 28 of them. I'm so proud for everybody, the county board, the players, everybody else. I mean, I think it's a tremendous day from Offaly. And it just goes, but this shows what can be done when players are brought along the right way.
Certainly the move of Brian Whelan, I know he's had flu over the last 24 hours, to pull forward, change things.
Brian Whelan had a terrible flu. He's on very heavy medication. His legs were totally, totally dead. I think the back from Muckworth, Corn and Peronine, that was the changing of the match. But every single one of the players, every single one of the 18 that played, they were really fabulous.
We do realise you're in for canonisation now in Offaly.
I don't know what I'm in for, but I'm so glad. I'm so glad for all of them, you know.
Thank you, Michael Bond.
So Offaly are the champions, led by Michael Bond. It's been a long, long season for them. The fans have travelled every part of the championship with their team. And the side that got beaten in the Leinster final have come good in the final of the All-Ireland itself. Wonderfully joyous scenes for Offaly people. But that move by Brian Whelan up to full forward, that's the one that really turned things around. Joe McDonagh, President McAleese, and in the middle, relieved Hubert Rigney.
A Hishi, a Horde Gael, and Yerin, Agus Harlar, Tommy Teresh. Cléhe Canis, Amána na Héirin, Stairúil, Eichal, in Seanyol. A hei dasach báire, bá wail an fírchín fáilte a chór rai bhuachtarán na Héirin ar a cétharas go pártin chróki. Gwí mít gach rahort a uachtarán ar a réitse i gás. Bá wail an tréslú leis na Amánaithe. Amánaithe, I Valley agus Kilkenny, a hog lua a gaeth a gnaw agus an anam fáilt le himara inyo. Tog ordechus le conde I Valley, a thai cort an carro creib na hair an arasht tolshana. Nira vae la Kilkenny e inyo, a gawin bwechus lo a sot an sarhus bantus a hugadar dóin. Ba wala bwecha spesialta a gawal le Colach Guinness agus an sialam ta Sean Halliday banishtar stiolha Colach Guinness gara maha Guinness agus ag Sean. Bwechas da Dicky Murphy agus das na mair tívni na Seanie McMahon, Pat O'Connor agus na mair Ellen. Ha Rutherbeek gawamid bwechas le amánaithe na héirin a hog sár has bántis skillin a dóin i reich na bléana. Ach a chórde, Jenna Ray, e siad amánaithe I Valley, curry creif na héirin don bléan reidag sa nécha hoc. Agus an ish, is cúslór áhastam, curran vi cárthi a vrana, chapte an vókaf I Valley, Hubert Rigney.
It's a glorious moment for Offaly, for their captain Hubert Rigney. The Liam McCarthy Cup is won by Offaly. Champions for the fourth time ever. What a remarkable last 20 years it's been. Billy Dooley in there. What a day for the Dooley family. Johnny Pilkington as well. And a day for all of these Offaly fans here in Croke Park, at home in Offaly itself, and Offaly people, of course, also throughout the world. I mentioned he was shy.
Look around. Look around. Inter Offaly. Con Noha Thurum and Karen Shaw Agalaka and Brian Offaly. Mr. President, President GAA, people of Offaly, we've done it! We may have come in through the back door, but we're going out the front! There's a lot of people that needs to be thanked for this day, and really I don't know where to start. We have started training since last October for this. I want to especially mention the places that get the venues for training during the year. I'd like to mention a special thanks to Shinrón GAA for the indoor training. Also to the St. Rainer's GAA Club for providing their facilities. And lastly, to Tullamore GAA for their facilities. I want to thank the sponsors, Karen Meads, and any other people who sponsored us during the year, especially five lads back in the middle of January who sponsored us for indoor training up in Shinrón. Board and all its officials, and I want to thank Pat McLaughlin and Paul Mulhare, who've been with us for the whole year.
Speech by the winning captain then, Hubert Rigney of Offaly. And just to go back to a point that Ger Canning made when he said that Offaly today had beaten one of the big powers of hurling, I think Offaly will count themselves to be one of the big powers of hurling in the 90s. Tremendous game, tremendous scenes, wonderful excitement in this year's Guinness All-Ireland Hurling Final. And it seems to me that the entire county of Offaly is down on the pitch at the moment celebrating with its players this victory. I'll be finding out the thoughts of Cyril Farrell and Tomás Mulcahy in just a moment. We have a commercial break to take. We'll be back with analysis of this game shortly.
The New Furniture Centre Cork Super Anniversary Sale is now on. Massive reductions in sitting room, dining room, kitchen and bedroom furniture. Open 7 days and on Sunday, 2:30 to 6.
In any game, there's only one winner. Berger Paints. Looking good. Lasting longer.
Your content. of Ireland Football Championship.
Give him the left, give him the right. Well, an all-roundy money.
You're not going to believe it, Butty Brennan.
What? Your mammy doesn't know you're out?
Yeah. No. Playing the lotto was going up from 50 to 75p a penny.
Well, only that's because the cost of your dreams has gone up a fair bit since the lotto began 10 years ago. Look, haven't you always dreamed of a place of your own?
With a bet. And a nice comfy bed.
Well, only the cost of your dreams has gone up an awful lot since you started dreaming. That's why it costs a little bit more to play.
So that's why the minimum jackpot is doubled to a guaranteed £1 million for every single draw.
That's right. You ought to get new prizes, bigger prizes.
And more money for good causes, Butty.
That's right.
Butty, do you have a dream?
Nothing that money can buy, Roundy. Nothing that money can buy.
Because dreams cost a lot or more, from September 26th, there's a lot or more to play for. Centrum contains a complete and balanced range of 31 vitamins, minerals and antioxidants necessary to maintain long-term good health. Centrum, complete from A to Zinc.
Jennings New Truck Center, Tullamore, County Offaly, probably the country's largest commercial vehicle garage. Main Iveco, Hino and Isuzu dealers. Call now for sales, service and parts.
Flakiest milk chocolate in the world.
From award-winning cooked ham and delicatessen meat products to pre-pack ready meals for quality and service, make Carol Meats your number one.
Standard Life. Enjoy a better standard of living.
Well, the cheering and the general hubbub may have died down a little bit here at Croke Park, but the Offaly supporters still on the pitch, savouring this wonderful victory today. Mingling down there, indeed, with Kilkenny supporters who are looking at the way that their team lost this All-Ireland final. And after the match, one interesting little thing that I noticed. As the Offaly crowd ran out onto the pitch to congratulate their heroes, a lot of their supporters took the time to commiserate with the Kilkenny players on the pitch, which I thought was a nice touch. Today, Offaly became All-Ireland champions. Offaly rampant indeed, Cyril Farrell.
Fantastic display, Michael. They've been threatening to do that all year. They did it the last day against Clare as well the other day, but like, I think it's probably the best day sort of Offaly for, you know, even compared to the older teams. Like, it's no wonder that the crowds are out there savouring this moment, because like, they really put on an exhibition today, and from young Stephen Byrne, who goes right up the whole way. And, like, what a season's been for the likes of Joyers, who won a club campaign with Bourne, you know, had a bereavement in, a big bereavement, and like the fellow with Hurling Moore and Luna Knight. And I think like there'll be fantastic celebrations. On the day, there was no doubt they were the better team. They were kind of, you know, at half time went in 2 points down. I suppose they had a look as well, because like, as you were saying there, Michael, in the second half, it seemed the breeze turned for them again. But the breeze hadn't a big effect, it was just their power hurling. And like everyone involved in them deserved great credit. It was a fantastic display.
At the beginning of the year, people speculated that a hurling manager from Loughrea would lead a team to an All-Ireland victory, and they were right.
That's very true, Michael. But at the beginning, it's very true. Like, you know, Michael Bond wasn't involved at that stage. But like, he's as a fairy tale. Like, as I wrote there during the week, if he wins this one, it's a fairy tale come true, because like, he's been involved for a few months. He's transformed awfully. Okay, everyone knew that the hurlers were there, but like, they brought him, they pulled him out of the hat. Like, as Hubert Rigney said there, like, they probably didn't even know him to train him, but they know him now. And of course, well, the hard thing now, of course, for Michael is he has to stay on and he has to win another one. But the talent is there, like, and you know, it's fantastic times for Offaly hurling.
Let's look at some of the key scores of that second half, Tomás. And this is wonderful stuff from Offaly. Joe Erity, when he scored the goal, he was running towards us, and there was goal in his mind at the time he collected this ball.
Yes, I mean, at this time in the second half, when you need leaders and you need guys with inspiration, Joe Erity showed us today. I mean, he puts his head down, everything on his mind is goal. Liam Keown does very well coming across. but it's a great shot. I mean, if you see it from behind the goal, he's goal written on his mind. Watch the MPO number 7, comes out, short of charge, but Joe Erity was so cute, a ground shot and into the corner of the net, gave the goalkeeper no chance whatsoever. And I mean, at a stage in All-Ireland final, you need players like that, you need players to show determination, take their chances, put the head down, and certainly Joe had a great game to get in the second half.
You need to back up scores like that, sir, with points from out the field as well. And we saw two superb examples of this from Brian Whelehan and from Pilkington.
Well, I'd say that Brian Whelehan, if he had a few before this, he'd won the career today. He's probably the best hurler. Again, now here you see him under the ball. Look at the skill here. He's well tackled, throws it down in his right. He's going to swerve again, goes around again, and flicks it over the bar. He was doing that all day. He was up full forward, up wing forward. The same against Lewis again now. Another lovely score. Like, again, see from a reverse angle. He has all the skills, he can play him anywhere, centre back, wing forward, full forward. He's often done that in championship hurling for Burr, when they'll be well behind. But like, the influence he had today was just unbelievable. Here's another long, long ball coming right in here again. Johnny Pilton, another great score. At this stage, Offaly are on the floor. Like, Johnny needed a big one because he was in for a lot of criticism during the year. Like, he always answered the critics in his own way. Like, Offaly now are at full forward, they're doing fantastic hurling at this stage. And like, there'll be great celebrations in Burr tonight.
Well, Limerick found out a couple of years ago what that felt like. Joe Erty was involved again in Offaly's next score. This one was Brian Whelan. Now, they said Brian Whelan had a touch of the flu. A goal and 6 points is not bad of the flu, is it?
Sure. Whatever type of flu it was, he had a terrific game. And again, if you see the ball breaking in here, pulled by John Troy, comes inside, and Joe Erty is there to pick it up again. That's it. His inspiration. He missed, hit his shot, it came across to Brian Whelan, and there he was to finish in the back of the net. A great play again by Joe Erty. I mean, every time he got the ball in the second half, he was willing to take on his markers. Miss hit the ball here, but Brian Whelan's in the right place, and in deftest of touches to finish at the back of the net. What a marvellous contribution from a full forward for Brian Whelan.
Well, the players obviously involved in this pulsating All-Ireland final have now got a chance to get their breath back, or partly so anyway. Marty Morrissey is down in the dressing room area now.
Yes, and it's a rather hectic place to be, Michael, I can assure you. Great celebrations here. Johnny Dooley, another All-Ireland medal, but what a way to win it.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. It's great there in the second half. The commitment shown by the players was unbelievable. And our backs was to the wall at half-time. We were 2 points down playing after playing with the breeze. So we had it all to do at half-time. And I think we showed out there in the second half that this team has unbelievable fight-back spirit.
You've done it more than once, of course, this year.
Yeah, well, we've done it a couple of times there in the Clare games, and we had a couple of hard games behind us, and I think it stood to us in the second half today.
How difficult was it outside there? Because looking from on the ground as such along the sideline, the wind was so difficult, it was swirling all the time.
Yeah, there was a funny type of a breeze out there. It actually changed a bit in the second half, and I think it favoured us slightly. But having said that, when things were going bad for us, we really put it together, and then second half was a great performance.
Well, certainly the man beside you will be remembered for a long time around Burr, and indeed Offaly. Great goal, but I always knew you was a full-back, Joe Erty.
Yeah, I couldn't make it back there to show me up the other end of the field. I think we'll all be remembered for today's performance. It was great character in the team today. As Johnny said, our backs were to the wall at half-time, and we had a sort of a chat to ourselves at half-time, and we said there's no way we were going down here without a fight. And the spirit in the team is absolutely unbelievable, and it showed there in the second half today. Total commitment, and when we got on top, we stayed on top, you know.
It was your goal, though, that set them on the road to victory. It was indeed symptomatic of the whole Offaly team. Great determination that actually got you the score.
Yeah, I suppose, I mean, I got a break and I wasn't going to get a strike for a point, so I just put my head down and went for it. And I suppose from that goal on, the whole team just lifted. And our backspur got completely on top then and dropped ball and ball down on top of us. And we got a percentage of them for scores and that, you know. But overall, a great team performance, you know.
Well, let me move on to the man who's, I think, described as the find of the year, goalkeeper Stephen Byrne. You had to do it again today.
Well, it's like this, Marty. I have this and I'm not going to let it go. I'm not going to let this one go now for a while. It's been a great year. It's unbelievable, like, first year in the camp. And the lads are just, unbelievable. Like, I told you that the last day. I said, from 1 to 15, no matter how many lads are criticised, from the midfield in, our lads are criticised. Prove today. We're the best in Ireland.
But considering your performances during the year, the last couple of games, the last game against Clare, and again today, you had to really produce a miraculous save.
Well, Marty, it's like this. As I said to you, you know, every game is different. You have to go with the same frame of mind for every game. If you don't, you won't play well. And you have to concentrate. And it's not Ireland final, you have to concentrate.
You've answered all your critics, not just you. I know you got a bit of stick over that simple goal. Anybody can make a mistake anyway, Stephen, right? But that simple goal against Antrim, you've answered all your critics.
Yeah, well, these things happen. Like, you know, it even happens to the best of goalkeepers. And, you know, you just have to pick yourself up and plug away and get stuck in for the next day.
I'm sure an all-star might be heading your direction.
We won't talk about that yet, Marty. We'll talk about tonight now. You're over tonight.
What do you think this is going to mean to everybody in Offaly, though? The way you won it as well.
It's going to be unbelievable for young people, Marty. It's going to be unbelievable. Like, we needed a lift in the county with hurling, especially for the youth, and it's going to be unbelievable. It's going to be unbelievable. They'll all be out with hurling.
Well, congratulations on a great year for you personally as well. Thank you, Stephen Byrne.
Yes, well, we heard a moment ago there from the goal scorer, Joe Erity, and of course the Borough players, so much a part of this Offaly success. You have the Quillahans and the Pilkingtons, of course, involved there, the Hanafies as well. Great excitement, obviously, all over Offaly, not least so down in Borough, and not least so down in Quillahans pub there, the pub run by Simon Quillahan, of course, Brian and Patro, and there they all are. Let's go over live to Quillahans in Borough.
Yes, the excitement is intense down here in Burr, and all the fans have started to party already. When do you think you had it won?
I honestly thought when Jory put the ball in the back of the net, I thought that was the time that Offaly started to hurl well in the forward line, and that's when I think things came right for Offaly.
There was a lot of nail biting up to that stage. Did you think the lads did well?
I thought they hurled fantastically well, but Brian Whelan was sick all day yesterday. He was in bed with the flu. They changed him from the forward, or from the back line into the forward line. I honestly thought that was a big array for Offaly. Brian can hurl anywhere, and he proved it today. That's an awful great thing to have a player like that in any team.
And did you think that the fact that Offaly had more matches helped the situation?
I honestly, they were a lot fitter, they were a lot better. They also that, like, the likes of the Whelans, the Bannerman, it's a small pick from Offaly. We have a great team and we have a big band of players, and that's the most important. We have heart. We have heart.
What's this win going to mean?
Oh, it means everything. Absolutely everything. It's great for the town, it's great for the county and the players. They worked hard to get it and I knew they could do it. Everyone here, as you can see, is absolutely ecstatic, overwhelmed by the win. But we knew they could beat it. When they bet clear, we knew they could get the Cats.
What kind of a party are we going to have tonight?
Oh, a live one.
What was the finest moment for you in the match?
Oh, the last two goals were just stopped my heart from ticking.
Was there anyone here who doubted that Offaly would do it?
No!
Okay, back to you, Michael. The party has just begun.
And welcome back here to the cash room, I think, underneath the Hogan stand. Brian Whelan, just tell me exactly, when did you get the flu?
Well, Marty, I suppose I picked it up early in the week, and we trained during the week, and I seemed to get rid of it. But yesterday morning I woke up and I was absolutely dying in the bed, and I got an antibiotics off our local doctor, and I saw Brendan Lee last night. And, you know, I had more stuff in me just today than probably any athletes going around on the circuit at the minute. But I seemed dead or something today, and I think only for the switch today I probably could have been switched to the line, and I'd like to thank our selector for moving me up, because it took, it wasn't in the game, and I think it helped out our backs as well, you know.
Well, I'd hate to see you when you're fully alive if you're half dead today. I think a goal and 6 points I made it, something like that along the sideline, but the goal in particular put the icing on the cake, to use the cliche.
Well, Marty, yeah, Jordy, he picked up a ball and went right at them, and had got in for a shot, and I think he went to go same as his first goal, a drop shot, and seemed to hit the heel of his hurl. And Pat O'Neill committed himself to Joe. The ball just came across to me, and I'd say if I missed it, I'd have been shot. But thankfully, it broke very well for me, and what can I say? We're All Ireland champions, and it was a great display.
Well, well done, Brian. It's a great moment for the Whelans, because the younger brother was at number two. Well done today, Simon.
Thank you very much, Marty. Thanks very much. It's a great day for Offaly, and especially us. Like, what a year. Two All Irelands in the 1 year. Like, it's something special. Like, I hope to God it lasts forever. Like, oh my God, fantastic.
But it's some way to win it.
Oh, in the first half now, we were very poor. Like, we didn't know where we were. But to come back, the performance we gave in the second half now was unbelievable. I'm delighted for everybody. Like, we just knuckled down, put our hits together, and we hooked, blocked, cleared balls off the line. Like, we deserve to win, actually.
Well, one man who was cheering on the other two brothers, Barry, I'm sure it was nerve-wracking for you.
Oh, geez, I was just dying to end there. The two boys were brilliant. The whole team was brilliant. I'm just delighted for everybody. I thought we didn't have a great first half, and Brian didn't go well. And I see a minute we did the bar line, everything started to work out for us. Slightly for every day, and we'll have a great night tonight.
I'm sure there'll be wild celebrations and bonfires in Burr, Kilcormac, Tullamore.
Oh, everywhere. We're going to have a right here now.
Well done to the Whelan brothers. Congratulations, lads. Well done. Indeed, a great moment here in the...
Yeah, going on a right tear, I bet there's no doubt about that. Isn't it incredible when you come to think of it, the way that Offaly have won their two All-Irelands in the 90s? That game against Limerick and, of course, this year's championship then. Well, one of the doubters, I suppose, along the way at one stage was Pete Finnerty, but he changed his mind about Offaly, and I have no doubt that he congratulates them on their success. Jim Carney is with him.
Thank you very much indeed, Michael. Well, Peter Finnerty, you've always expressed your admiration for Kilkenny hurling, but today you went for Offaly. You stuck with them at half-time. What is it about these remarkable men that so appealed to you?
I suppose the people down in Whelan's pub will probably break the television or say he finally got it right. But at half-time, I felt that if Offaly were with Kilkenny, that this fighting spirit that they've displayed against Clare would come through in the finish, and they would bottle up Kilkenny and tighten up on the slack marking that they were showing in the first half. And I felt that they came through. It was a tremendous game of hurling, probably the best game of hurling that we've seen this year, even though their last game was very good as well. And there was talk before the match, they were giving away tickets outside. Now, anybody who gave away a ticket for this game today missed an awful lot.
It's the first thing you said after the match, Pete, that it was a great game of hurling. What did you particularly like about it?
It was the sheer commitment, determination, the pace at which it was played at, and not a wrong blow drawn all day. Like, it's an amateur sport, you know, and we see soccer every day of the week, and it's a great game as well. But what we saw today in Croke Park can be matched by no game in the world.
Peter, you played in 5 All-Ireland finals at right half-back. Tell us what it must feel like for a right half-back to score 1-6 in a final.
It's incredible. There was a rumour out that Brian Whelan had the flu, but that rumour has gone to a great switch by the selectors now at this stage. Mm. Brian was struggling at wing-back early in the first half, but he's moved to wing-forward. He seemed to settle, get into the game, get his second wind. He was superb. Like, he's a magnificent hurler. You could play him anywhere. And he scored 1-6 from dead ball situations and from frees, and that's some contribution.
Finally, Peter, a word about the gallant losers. I heard you say when you came in, Pat O'Neill is shattered.
Yeah, I met Pat there and he was absolutely shattered. He was in tears afterwards, as you know, and that's the kind of a player that Pat is, himself and Willie O'Connor and DJ and players like that. They give it everything and you're so drained, you never think about losing, but when the day comes that you do lose, everything is gone, there's no back door in the final, and it is very depressing for the losers, but fair play to Offaly, they did it. And well done. Have a good drink tonight, lads. I'll buy you one if I meet you.
Thank you, Peter Finnerty. Back to Michael.
No point in asking Pete Finnerty what it's like to score a goal and 6 points from a wing back, because he never did, I'm sure. Cyril Farrell, about Kilkenny today. I mean, defensively, I thought they played well. I thought Kenneth Brennan had a stormer today. Pat O'Neill was himself and all that. And yet, they conceded 2 goals and 16 points.
Yeah, well, Offaly were on top even in the first half. We remarked that here at half-time. With all the play Offaly had, they weren't putting the ball away. Now, Kilkenny were living on scraps, really. And again, in midfield, okay, Philly Larkin came into it strong. But, like, Peter Barry never got to grips. You know, it just wasn't one of his days. Coming for just trying hard, it wasn't happening either. You know, it wasn't happening to half forward, and the ball wasn't going in that often. The Offaly half-backs midfield started really to dominate. Now, Offaly have played a kind of a simple play, really, all year. They played, say, Michael Dydenmore as a third midfielder. Johnny Dooley out there with Johnny Pilkin has worked. Now, Brian Whelan moved up wing forward. Okay, he had the flu of souls, but, like, he picked off 2 or 3 points the first half. But he's a brilliant hurler, and he's done it often for Burr. And, like, Kilkenny will look back, and, like, they've had a good year. Okay, the league was scrappy enough because they're trying to get a team together, and yet, like, in the championship they've only lost one match, but the important thing is they've lost the final, so they're out of it. Now, they'll be disappointed tonight, there's no doubt about that, but if they look back at it in retrospect, they'll find, like, you know, that the year was quite, you know, it has been a good year, and just have to build on that again.
If you were a forward out there in that Kilkenny forward line today, Tomás Mackay, you would have been a frustrated player.
Certainly, and I kind of thought at half-time if they kept you letting the ball through to the forward line or the full forward line segment, that they would cause problems, but they just seemed to hold up the ball too much, I think, and there was no directness in their play, and they bunched it up in the second half. But you've got to give credit to Offaly on the other side. I mean, in fairness to them, they tightened their back line very, very strong, and the two cornerbacks came out into the game very, very strong. And DJ, we didn't see DJ in the second half, and in an All-Ireland final, when DJ scores 5 points, then he gets them all from frees, it just shows the type of player Offaly defenders play today, and you have to give credit to Offaly.
Okay, gentlemen, well, it's almost time for us to leave Croke Park, but I'm sure Offaly people won't want us to leave here on what has been surely a beautiful day for them.
What a beautiful day! Went back But some say that that's impossible, but you and I would never look back. And wasn't it incredible? So beautiful and above all, just to see the fuse get lit this time, to light a real bonfire for all time. And what a beautiful day.
So, as we say, congratulations then to Offaly and, of course, to the Miners of Cork. We leave you from Croke Park, but do remember to join us later on in the evening for the Sunday game at 9.30 when we look back on today's final. We'll also be joining the Offaly team at their victory banquet, analysing the game, of course, and we'll be naming our man of the match from this year's 1998 Guinness All Ireland Hurling Final. My thanks again to Tomás Mulcahy and to Cyril Farrell for joining me here on the presentation box. We hope to see you later on. Until then, bye bye. We'll be right back.